Welcome to Allan Trimble Stadium on the campus of Jenks High School. It's the Ford game of the week, the Jenks Trojans hosting the Norman Tigers. Hi, everybody. Mike Ziegenhorn alongside me, Dion Amade, and it's a district showdown. It is week number 8. We're closing in on the end of the regular season.
Hard to believe, but yes, we're almost to the end, and both of these teams have to win, okay? For Norman, they got to win to get into the playoffs, and for Jenks, they got to keep winning to stay at the position that they're at.
All right, let's take a look at some of the key players in tonight's football game. First for Norman, Joe Willie.
He's more of that slasher back. Speed, does a good job running between the tackles, but look for him in the passing game. He does excellent things in the open field. Very explosive guy. We should have fun watching him tonight.
And the other side for Jenks, also a running back, senior Jacob Shelley, set a career record last week.
Yes, and this is a big, strong kid. The senior is really coming into his own. He runs hard, and if you get in his way, he'll run over you as well.
All right, the kickoff coming up next. Jenks and Norman, it's the Ford game of the week on YurView. Stay tuned.
Game Time on YurView is brought to you by your Oklahoma Ford dealers, the best in Oklahoma. AirCo, the company you know. Tulsa Tech, for your future success, go to tulsatech.edu. And by Weoki Credit Union. Join us all fall long for some of the top high school football from around the country on Game Time.
During Ford SUV season, find out why more people come back to Ford than any other brand. Here's a reason.
We've got room.
And here's another.
Waze says it's faster to take the side streets.
Perfect.
And by the way, Ford has won more J.D. Power initial quality awards than any other brand. During Ford SUV season, get 0% for 72 months plus 1,000 bonus cash on Escape, Edge, and Explorer. See your Oklahoma Ford dealer today.
Weoki's new money certificate rates are incredible. Transfer money from another institution to a Weoki 35-month certificate and receive 3.05 APY. Yes, that's over 3%. And get a $100 cash bonus for new CD amounts of $100,000 and greater. Open your certificate with new money at Weoki and start earning incredible rates. Federally insured, rate and bonus are for new money only. Other terms and limitations apply. Contact Weoki for details.
Welcome back to Allan Trimble Stadium on the campus of Jenks High School. It's the Ford game of the week. 6-1 Jenks taking on 4-3 Norman. Mike Ziegenhorn, Dion Amade with you on this beautiful Friday night in Jenks America. 56 degrees, there's no rain, it's moved through. Perfect night for football. As a former player, you love weather like this, and how about the keys to the game?
Yes, sir. Finally, somebody actually knows what football weather actually is, okay? Let's check out these keys for the game. Number one, cruising for a bruising, okay? That means these teams have to string together some drives. Put together some solid drives, and you'll have some success tonight. Number two, don't get it away. No turnovers. Offensively, you gotta stay with the football. No turnovers. Number three, keep it small. And when I say keep it small, I mean no big plays. If they try to go over the top on you, secondary, safeties, corners, you have to be able to defend the big play. Hopefully they get that done tonight.
We're taking a look at Keith Riggs, the head football coach here at Jenks, his first season after Allan Trimble retired at the end of the 2017 season. It is senior night here in Jenks tonight. They were pretty much lined up from goal line to goal line with the seniors and their parents and family members. I can tell you that Jenks did win the toss. They will defer and get the ball in the second half, so they are going to kick off from right to left on your TV screen. That means Norman will be heading south as we get this one underway. All-time series in this one, Jenks leads it 6-1. The only victory in the series for Norman, you got to go all the way back to 1992. They beat Jenks in a Class 6A semifinal, 14-8, Dion. And that was the last state championship Norman won in 1992, and the first ever 6A champion in high school football in the state of Oklahoma. So a little bit of trivia for you. How about that?
1992 must have been a good year. That was the year I was born. So maybe I'm lucky for these Norman Tigers.
There you go. Well, it wasn't a lucky night for Norman as they made the trek over here. One of their buses broke down in Stroud, and part of the team was late getting here. The team, rest of the team came. They got the cheerleader bus. They made a call. The cheerleaders were already here. They sent the cheerleader bus to get the rest of the team to come on over. So
the cheerleaders were the heroes.
Yeah,
this
they
story,
were the
huh?
heroes, exactly. And there you see the Trojans set to take the field on this Friday night. It is fall break in Oklahoma. A majority of the games, probably 85 to 90% of them, played last night. But there are a few teams that are playing tonight, and this is one of those games. And it was our Ford fan pick game of the week.
Yes, sir. It sure was. You guys voted. This is the game that you wanted to see. And here it is. It was a little bit of an awkward week for both of these teams with it being fall break. So schools being out, you have to, you know, coordinate schedules and get kids over here to practice. But both of these coaches said they had good, solid weeks of practice. So we should go to see a strong performance here tonight.
And there you see the weather, 55 degrees, winds out of the south, 4 miles an hour. We were down on the field before the game. Of course, they have AstroTurf here and perfect conditions out there. We had rain all day here in the Tulsa area, pretty much off and on overnight, most of the morning. Rolled through, and it's all south of here moving out. The officials tonight, Robert Breedlove is your referee, Dr. Breedlove, Dale Anderson, Patrick Sweeney, Scott McKinley, and Lynn Hazelbaker, your crew here in Jenks tonight. On senior night, it is week number 8 of the high school football season. Final home game of the year for Jenks. They go to Santa Fe and Westmore to wrap up 2018. We talked about Norman needing to win. I mean, Jenks pretty much has a playoff spot locked up. They want to try and finish second since they've already lost to Broken Arrow. Norman, they've got to have some things happen for them to make the playoffs, but the scenario is what there. If they win out, obviously that helps. If they don't win tonight, they still can win the next 2 weeks, and they can still make the playoffs.
You always want to be in charge of your own destiny. And right now, for them to be in charge of their own destiny, they got to win out, and they got to start here tonight winning.
Kick taken right at about the 2-yard line. And swarmed under before he could cross about the 10. Jenks says there's a fumble. They've got the ball. And here's the Norman offense. I guess it's going to stay with the Tigers. Ben Sparks, Braden Andrews, Robert Kowalski, Yemi Oceania, and Grant Goodson, the front guys. Harvey Cooper, Andrew Young, Jonah Payton, Tyler Crump, and Joe Willie starting tailback on the season. They're averaging just a little over 22 points a game. Take a look at the Jenks defense. After this first play, Cade Horton with a high ankle sprain. Nursed it a little bit last week in their win over Enid, 45-35, and getting back to full strength. First play of the game, they do hand it off to number 6, Joe Willie. Runs it off the left side. And a nice gain as they quickly get to the line of scrimmage. Ernest Grayson, Travion Sear, Blake Isham, Matthew Minix, Jared Galley, James Pruitt, Noah Hernandez, Landis Morris, Wilcox, Braden Phipps, and Blake Pitcock round out the Jenks defense. Second down, pass complete by Horton as he hits Harvey Cooper. Good for a first down and across the 30-yard line. Nice play.
And that's an excellent way to start the drive. A nice little 7 route right here. He puts the ball in the perfect spot, right on that uphill shoulder for the wide receiver. And number 1, Cooper brings it in for these Norman Tigers.
Second down, Horton's going to keep. And hit pretty hard as he crosses the 35.
Yeah, and that's a good job by Horton, just getting up the field and getting what he can get. This is what we're going to see a lot from him tonight. Remember, Zig, that last time we saw Norman over here for your view on the Ford game of the week, Horton did a good job running the ball as the quarterback and adding an extra dimension to this offense. Let's see if he can do it again tonight.
Scrambling, had a wide open receiver. There wasn't anybody near Joe Willie, and a little bit high over his head. You talked what Horton has done offensively on the year. He's carried the ball 60 times for 490 yards and 5 touchdowns. So that is an element to the game. Also thrown for just over 1,000 yards on the season.
Yes, one of those dual threat type of quarterbacks that can really get it done with his feet and his arm. That time on that last play, doesn't really get it done with his arm.
third down and complete as he aims for Andrew Young. So they did get a first down in that series, but will have to punt as it's a fourth and seven. Yeah, he's got to be frustrated. Had that wide open Joe Willie on second down.
Yeah, that's the ones that you kind of think back on and really, really, God, I wish we could have that one back.
Coach Rocky Martin in his second year, 3-9 overall. He replaced Greg Nation, who had been there nine seasons. Martin has also coached at PC West here in Oklahoma. And last year took the team to, well, in 2016, they went to the postseason. With a 7-4 record. That punt is down at about 34-yard line. Let's take a look at the Jenks lineup. Brady Latham, already committed to go to Arkansas next year. Max Johnson, Hunter Hoyt, Carter Brestovansky, and John Roberts up front. Dylan O'Keefe at tight end. Julian Clark has really stepped it up the last few weeks at wide receiver. Blake Pitcock, Jacob Shelley, and Jason Waters in the backfield. Grayson Waters averaging 36 points a game. Ian Corwin, who is now the all-time passing leader yardage-wise and completions in the history of Jenks football, the senior leading the way for the Trojans, and the first handoff is fumbled for Jenks as the Trojans don't get it. And it was Waters who fumbled it.
Yes, sir. They tried the little end around right here. Just the snap is kind of directly in Ian Corwin's hand, so there's no problem there. But when he turns around to give Waters the ball, he kind of puts it up high into his chest and not his belly. Kind of hits Drayson in the hands, and he fumbles it. Luckily enough for Norman, they're able to bounce on top of it. Great field position. Let's see what they can do with it here.
Cade Horton in the offense trot right back out there. Fakes it to Willie and pass too high for his intended receiver, Jonah Payton. Payton the leading receiver on the season for this Norman football team. When we did the game at Moore, we saw some of that out of Horton where some of his passes were too high.
Yeah, just a little inaccurate on some of his open receivers. Hopefully he gets that corrected and has a better night tonight.
Second 10. Norman sitting with nice field position as the Jenks offense turned it over on first down. Horton looking. Nice move. Big yardage. Andrew Young down inside the five.
And that's Andrew Young. This is a guy who has a bunch of ability on the outside for these Norman Tigers. If they're going to want to win tonight, they're going to have to get the ball in his hand. Look at the speed on the outside. He stumbles just a little bit and allows Jenks to catch up to him. I think if he doesn't stumble, he might go in for the score right there.
Young's 32nd catch on the year. Over now 600 yards receiving. Horton's going to keep on first down, and he is squashed right at the line of scrimmage. Bring up a second down and goal from about the 7-yard line.
Yeah, just a zone read over there to the boundary side. So everything's a little convoluted. Tries to find some open space, but doesn't get anything on the play.
Horton again, trying to carry defenders with him. He gets inside the five. It's going to be third and goal from inside the five.
Kind of anticipated a passing play on that down right there. Second down in the red zone. Kind of your opportunity to take a shot and try to get some free room right here on third down. It's going to be interesting to see what they do here on about the 4-yard line.
Horton's committed to Ole Miss to play baseball. OU has also shown interest, said, hey, you can come play baseball and quarterback. We already got another guy on our team that does that too.
Might as well. He's right down the street.
Third and goal. Horton, right side. And Trey Hasimovich catches it, but goes down immediately, so it's going to bring up a fourth down and a field goal try for the Tigers.
And that's just an excellent play by number 21, Will Cox. They do a nice little pivot route towards the outside, but it doesn't fool him. He's Johnny on the spot and brings him down, and here comes the field goal unit.
Junior Grady Wade. Snap, and Wade, it is good. RB Cooper did a nice job putting the snap down, and Wade kicked it through the uprights. So Norman strikes first with the early 3-0 lead off the Jenks turnover. Kind of a short drive, short field as they head down from the 30, Dion, and get in scoring position.
Yeah, and it's a good job by this offense of at least getting down there and getting some points on the board after the turnover. But it's an even better job, in my opinion, by this Jenks defense. You get a sudden change, you got to go right back onto the field, but you don't panic. You let the couple plays go into the red zone, but you keep them out of the end zone. Get 3 points, that's a win for the defense.
Hey, take a look at Keith Riggs. First year at Jenks, 6-1 overall, but he's been here while involved in 7 state titles with the Trojans. Longtime assistant. He's been the defensive coordinator here at Jenks since 2010. Came to the program back in 2003. He's just trying to keep what Allan Trimble built going along. Jenks' only loss on the year was at Broken Arrow in district as they opened up district play week three. It was week four. 3 non-district games. They beat Bixby, Mansfield Legacy, and Union in the Mid-First Bank Backyard Bowl that you saw right here on YurView. And they open up district play against Broken Arrow and lost that one 28-13. Broken Arrow clearly the cream of the crop in the class. Number one team in Class 6A.
Yeah, that's a big physical group over there in Broken Arrow.
And it's off to the races. Finally pulled down and out of bounds. Braden Phipps.
That's a great return by Braden Phipps, seeing the alley and then going up the field and getting some big yardage for this Jenks offense.
Tevin Randall, Wyatt Weston, Braden Woods, and Cole Thompson, and Tyron Robb, along with Sam Wishin, Jackson Caldwell, the front 7. The Norman defense, Cedric Seals, Jaden Ford, Gunnar Luna, and Kevin Randall, allowing just 22 points a game.
The way the kicker made that tackle right there, Grady Wade could be over there playing safety for the Norman Tigers. Good job by him.
First down. Hand off and running right up the middle, Noah Hernandez. And big yardage for him, Dion. You don't see it that often right up the middle, do you?
That's excellent job. Good job pressing the hole and then in traffic, making guys miss and breaking tackles. That's the way you want to start this second possession for this Jenks offense with the first one, a fumble right out the gate. So hopefully they can get right back on track.
Second down, Hernandez again. Big hole, breaks a tackle. He's going to score. 37-yard touchdown from Noah Hernandez. And just like that, 2 plays, the Trojans have the lead.
And it's another one for Noah. Good job in the hole. Check out the replay. First, he presses the hole square, gets up the field, and his offensive line does a good job because he makes one guy miss and takes it all the way in for the Jenks touchdown.
PAT is good. Kick right through the uprights. Ethan Bernard. Jenks leads at 7-3. You're watching the Ford Game of the Week on YurView.
Game Time Keys to the Game are brought to you by Tulsa Tech. For your future success, go to tulsatech.edu. Join us all fall long for some of the top high school football from around the country on Game Time.
Are you looking to build a career in the high demand and high paying field of construction? What are you waiting for? Tulsa Tech offers affordable, hands-on training in state-of-the-art facilities. Great training that can give you confidence. Get trained in fields like carpentry, electricity, HVAC, masonry, and welding. To learn how Tulsa Tech can help you make your own path to a successful career, call 918-828-5000 or visit tulsatech.edu.
You're watching Game Time on YurView. For more in-depth coverage of the top players around, recruiting updates, behind-the-scenes access, and more, check out YurView.com.
First play of the game for their offense. After a nice kickoff return from Braden Phipps at a short field. Started Norman territory, 45 yards, two plays. Noah Hernandez, 37-yard touchdown run. Jenks on top by four.
Impressive drive, two plays. It took Noah Hernandez all of two to get into the end zone for the Trojans.
Ball bounces and over the head of Gunnar Luna. Norm will take over first and 10 at the 20.
Yeah, they missed a couple throws on their last drive, Norman did, and Cade Horton, remember, quarterbacks in these big games, they've got a little pregame jitters, adrenaline rushing, puts a little too much on the ball and they kind of get away from him. So hopefully he settled down here, he can come out here, run their offense and get some things going, string together a drive.
First down, this time the handoff. It's not Joe Willie this time, it's Xavier Smith.
Yes, sir. Does a good job finding the cutback. Doesn't get much, but gets 2 yards.
Xavier and Willie kind of flip-flop in and out. Smith again, looking for some running room, and he is met by two or three Trojan defenders that time.
That's a good job by the Trojan defense, getting inside that hole and putting Alexander to the ground.
Blake Isham, number 90, senior, 6'4", 220 pound. D lineman, you don't want to run into that brick wall.
No, sir.
He's having a little helmet issue, so he's got to come out. Dylan O'Keefe takes his spot on the field.
Trips receivers to the boundary side. Look for something here to the wide side.
Horton throwing deep. And a little bit too deep that time for his intended receiver, Jonah Payton.
And you see what the offense was trying to set up right there. Trips receivers to the boundary side. You sway the defense over there, push all the help to the three receiver side, and then you go backside and attack the single corner. This time, just a little too much mustard on that football for Horton, but look for them to go back to this. It's something that offenses always try to do. Attack the corner by himself. Test him early and see if he can handle the pressure.
So three and out this time. Payton will be back to punt. Fair catch is made by Phipps at about the 45-yard line. Close. Let's see where they mark it, at around the 43. And that's where Keith Riggs and the Jenks offense will take over for the third time tonight. Next Thursday night, the fourth game of the week, they're going to be at Edmond. The Bulldogs will be hosting number one ranked and undefeated Broken Arrow. Game time Thursday at 7 o'clock on YurView. Check out Edmond Memorial BA next Thursday at 7. YurView Channel 3. BA 8-0 for the first time since 1997, 21 years ago. Then they lost three straight. Bounced out in the first round of the playoffs. First pass complete to Braden Phipps from Corwin.
Yeah.
You can see why he's got so many passing yards.
Yeah, you can see it. Just a quick hitch play right here, finding the number three receiver in space, gets him the ball, gets the first down.
He took a helmet to the thigh or knee area.
Yeah, it's one of those. Hopefully he doesn't have a nice contusion over there on that thigh. Had a couple of those in my days. It makes it hard to walk the next morning.
Corwin. Hand off to Waters. And he's just muscled under right at about the 40. Give him a gain of three. Bring up a second seven.
Nice tackle by Tyron Robb right there. Coming from his linebacker spot, really nice aggressive tackle over there, bringing Waters down to the ground.
Braden Woods was there too, number 91, a 6 foot, 260 pound junior. Robb, one of their leading tacklers on the team, also leads the team in sacks. 4-1 again. Nice route, throw and catch that time as he hits Blake Pitcock.
Yeah, and just a nice 5 yard out of that trips formation. Good job by the corner though, coming out there and making the tackle. Luna, there's nothing you can really do about that in cover four, okay? As a cornerback, you're by yourself out there. Does a good job breaking on the football and just stopping the receiver and not allowing him to get the first down. Third down and two right here. Let's see what they get. Look like they got that heavy personnel in there.
Shelley and Hernandez in the backfield. It's to Noah. He's got a first down, and more. He may score again. How about that? Noah Hernandez, this time from 35.
He only needed two, but he said, no, sir, I'll take it all. Noah Hernandez for a second touchdown of the game. Only 5 minutes left in the first quarter, and he already has two. Watch the replay. Great blocking. Look, Shelley almost takes two guys out, and then Noah Hernandez showing off the speed, getting into the end zone. Man, having one hell of a night early in this game.
PAT is good, and it is 14-3. Jinx. Hernandez has touched the ball three times. He scored twice. How about that?
I'll take those numbers any day.
80 total yards rushing, too. He's tearing it up.
Don't forget he's starting on defense. I think somebody wants to be our player of the game, Zig.
He knew you were here, didn't he?
He knew.
He wanted to talk to you after the game.
He spotted us. Yeah, this Thorman offense, though, is going to have to put some things together when they come onto the field once again. Knowing what type of ball game this is going to be, they know this Jinx team is capable of scoring every time they touch the field. They got to string together some drives like the keys of the game were. Got to string together some drives, give this defense of Thorman some rest, and then put some points on the board.
Third time they've kicked it off here in the first quarter. That one will go to the end zone, and Norman will take over first and 10 from the 20-yard line. Nice little drive there by Jinx.
Yeah, just a couple of simple, easy throws for Ian Corwin, a couple of hitch routes, a couple 5 yards and out, and then you get the run from Noah Hernandez. Excellent blocking across the board from the offensive line. I mean, Shelley came in there at fullback and opened up a hole. They had a wingback that came up as well, opened some things up.
Four plays, 57 yards. Ate up almost 2 minutes of clock time. Horton running for his life as he tried to roll out to the left and now just lobs it up for his receiver near him. Is almost picked off as he was trying to hit Jonah Payton. And defensively read that one well.
And normally, if a quarterback doesn't have the arm strength of Horton, I say do not throw that football. But you can see he almost gets it there. He puts it too high up in the air, too much hang time, so the DB has enough time to turn around and adjust, or else it's a big play. Good job by number 15 over there, Pitcock, making the play.
Second down, handoff to Joe Willie. Tackled. Might have been Noah Hernandez on the tackle that time for Jinx. Third and 8 for the Tigers. Morton again. Plenty of room up the middle, and he's got a first down and more. He's going to slide down at about the 42, and he slides past second base.
That is a baseball player right there. That was one of the most impressive slides I've ever seen. Look at
where's the defense?
All the open space. I guess in the scouting report, they did not hear that Horton could run, almost like Noah Hernandez right there on that play.
And he keeps it again. That time up to the 45. He picked up 3. That last run, 27 yards. 20 yards, 20-yard run. He's got 27 total prior to that last one, so now he's at 30. That was a 3-yard pickup.
Yeah, and that might have been the spark this offense needed just to get some room and get some positive plays going, see what they turn into.
Pass caught. Not sure that was the intended receiver, but it worked out to Tyler Crump.
Crump at the right spot. Another first down for the Tigers. Keep the chains moving, Sky. Look at this replay. Nice form. Yeah, that's exactly who he meant to throw, Vic.
And the first down carry by Xavier Smith.
And good form tackle by Noah Hernandez right there in the hole.
Trojans last week got the shutout. First time in 2 years they had a shutout as they beat Memorial 35-0. No shutout tonight as they turned it over in their first series and Norman got a field goal out of it, but the Tigers now are marching here as the clock continues to wind in quarter number one. This drive started at the 20. They had a third down and long. And Cade Horton rambled for 20 yards to pick up the first and keep the drive going in there in Jenks territory. Another third down for the Tiger offense, 3rd and 6. Look again, pass complete.
And I told you, number 10, Young, has to be an asset for you tonight. Andrew Young doing a great job on that single receiver side. You can see they're attacking that single receiver side. Doing a good job of making a move on that pivot route, getting to the outside, and getting a bunch of yards for these Tigers.
Horton starting to get in a little bit of a rhythm. Joe Willie. Into the second level at the linebackers. Nice run for him.
Yeah, good vision. Way to stay patient and stay with inside the hole.
It's Grayson, number 48 for Jenks, in on the tackle that time. Joe Willie again, and that hole closed quick. And it wasn't that big of a hole to begin with. And Trojan defense shut that one down.
Yeah, a lot of penetration by the defensive line of Jenks. Kind of seemed like they were already in the backfield before everything took place. Looked like it was trying to see the number there who created that initial pressure that kind of stomped the play. Might have been number 52 down there.
Morton keeps, no. Throws a pass, and it is too high for Young. He was looking for a pass interference. Norman here, yeah, you want to get points. It looks like sending the field goal team.
Yeah, right there, you can check it out. It's just a nice slant route. They fake the play action. He has his man inside. I mean, it's a good job by number 8, Caleb Peters. I don't know if he was early or not. That's for the referees to say. There's no flag over there, and you know me, Zig. Always, no pass interference. I didn't see it. The refs didn't see it. It's a good defensive play to me.
Brady Wade from 29. And it is good. So Norman, another field goal. Oh, wait, there is a flag down.
Let's see what the call is going to be over here.
unless it's a more than a five-yard penalty, they aren't going to get a first. And
it looks, yes, it's roughing automatic.
Oh, it's roughing.
Personal foul, roughing the kicker.
Wow.
15-yard penalty. Half the distance to the goal, automatic first down.
Yeah, and it looked like that outside rusher over there came in and took the inaccurate angle and kind of tripped up the kicker on his finish. So therefore, it's an automatic first down, and Norman gets another shot at the end zone. Take a look at it right here. Oh, there's what happened. He trips up Noah Hernandez, and Noah Hernandez falls on the kicker. That's just unfortunate right there.
Good break for Norman as they get a first down. Horton again. Nobody to throw to, and Met still on his feet as he's fighting with Tristan Quillen and the Jenks defense. And he finally goes down.
Took a whole lot of Jenks defenders to take him down, though.
And we have another flag? We do have another flag. I think we're probably going to have a holding or a pass interference on the defense where that one's dropped.
I'm waiting for these offensive linemen to do a little clap that shows it's against the Jenks Trojans or to put their head down to see if it was against Norman. Looking at their body language right now, it doesn't look like they're happy because they would have been clapping by now. But it does turn out to be a good thing for the Norman Tigers. Looks like it's holding over there in the secondary, looking at where that flag is laying over there by that pylon.
We've got defensive holding on a receiver. It's still first down. Half the distance to the goal.
Half the distance to the goal on that. Then Robert Breedlove, the official, longtime dermatologist in the Stillwater area. 41 years he's been a doctor and a longtime official. 6A crew. Horton keeps to the outside. And he gets and another flag, and we're going to have offensive holding this time. A little pushing and shoving. Second time that's happened at the end of a play. And Horton and one of the Jenks players, Jared Galley, exchanging words, and there's the hold. So now they'll come back.
Now we're going back and
another
forth here.
Third time they've had a first down.
Back and forth here. And this is something that you can kind of expect.
Offensive holding on the white. First down again.
And I'm not trying to give excuse me, ref. I'm not trying to give excuses to these teams over here, but with it being fall break and with it being a situation where it's unusual for these teams to not go to school and have to practice and different things like that, you can see some mental lapse or some unfocusedness throughout the period of the game that you normally don't see week to week at this time of the season.
Horton, quick pass to Young, and barely got past the line of scrimmage.
And they try that wide receiver screen on the outside. You can see the offensive lineman coming up over there trying to help and put together some blocks, but just too much penetration and great sideline to sideline speed for the Jenks Trojans.
Travion Sire there for Jenks. Again, nailed as he throws it and passes incomplete as he went for Payton.
And he took a hit at the end of that throw right there. Man, just a free releaser. Looked like number 24 for the Jenks Trojans. Jared coming off scot-free. Jared Giles.
Third and goal. They had it down to the five after a Jenks defensive secondary holding penalty, and then they got a holding penalty on the very next play. And prior to all that, there was a roughing the kicker penalty. back shoulder throw and intended for Young, who wanted pass interference.
And that's just a good defensive play by Phipps over there, doing a good job. He tries to hit the back shoulder throw on that go route over there. Phipps playing it man on man in his hip pocket, and look at him fall off backhand. Look at him stab that hand right there. He doesn't swipe. That's what they tell those DBs all the time. They tell him, don't swipe, stab the hand in, and you let the receiver see you, and he drops the pass.
Phipps had a little jersey there too as well and got away with it.
Referees didn't see it. It didn't count.
So they're going for a field goal again, and that one is good. It also ends the first quarter. 14-6 our score after one. We'll be back with the second quarter. It is the Ford Game of the Week.
Look, if you're not the lead dog, the scenery never changes. That's why this is the view for every other full-size pickup. And this year, it's deja vu all over again. Because only the Ford F-150 gives you best-in-class torque, best-in-class payload, and you got it, baby, best-in-class towing. This is the big dog. This is the Ford F-150. It doesn't just raise the bar, pal. It is the bar.
Now get 0% financing for 60 months plus $4,250 cash back on a new F-150 at your Oklahoma Ford dealer today.
Weoki's new money certificate rates are incredible. Transfer money from another institution to a Weoki 35-month certificate and receive 3.05 APY. Yes, that's over 3%. And get a $100 cash bonus for new CD amounts of $100,000 and greater. Open your certificate with new money at Weoki and start earning incredible rates. Federally insured, rate and bonus are for new money only. Other terms and limitations apply. Contact Weoki for details.
Winter's just around the corner, so it's a great time to replace your furnace before you need it most.
A planned replacement can save you thousands of dollars while improving the comfort and efficiency of your home.
Don't get caught in the cold. Call Airco Service today.
The company you know.
No one thinks about their water heater until it fails.
At that point, you have a huge mess on your hands with water damage everywhere.
A planned water heater replacement can save you a lot of trouble.
Right now, you can save big on a new high-efficiency water heater.
Call Airco Service.
The company you know.
Welcome back on Your View. It's the Ford Game of the Week. High school football on this Friday night in Oklahoma. It is 14-6 Jenks on top of Norman. Trojans on two Noah Hernandez touchdowns. 137, the other 35. And then Grady Wade has kicked two field goals for Norman. And Coach Rocky Martin, you saw him fired up on the sidelines. If you're just joining us and you missed it, one of the Norman buses broke down on the way over here right around Stroud. So half the team got here on time. The other half had to wait for the cheerleader bus to come back and pick them up and bring them over here. And they got here about 40 minutes before kickoff.
Cheerleader saved the day.
Yeah. Short pooch kick. Looks like it's Hernandez and takes it, gets across 35-yard line. If you're going to do a pooch kick, I'd say don't kick it to him.
Yeah, let's not kick it to number three.
Since he scored twice tonight.
This Jenks Trojans offense has had pretty good field position early in this game.
Trojan fans, Arby's. Just like the Jenks Trojans, Arby's is an All-American Classic. And right now, text TROJANS to 2729.
So Jenks' first time to touch it here in second quarter. Two quick drives. Two plays and four plays the last two times they touched the ball. So six total plays means two touchdowns. Ian Corwin hands it off to number 21, Will Cox.
Yeah, and you're going to see a number of guys carry the football for this Jenks Trojans offense. Right there, you got Will Cox doing a good job getting up the field and getting 4 yards. You're going to see Noah Hernandez. You see Waters. You'll also see the player that we have spotlighted tonight, Shelley, also touching number 27. So it's going to be running back by committee the rest of the way for these Trojans here.
Down give to Waters. Spinning and nice run for him up to the 35 or 45.
Yeah, good tackle by number 93, Charles Prince, over there on the outside from his defensive end position, making sure that Waters doesn't get the first down and forcing it to be third and one. Look at this. Look at him follow his blockers. He gets out of that tackle, thinks he's free, and then Prince comes up and lays the wood.
Lays the wood, lost his helmet, had to go to the sidelines for a play. Third and short. Shelley and Hernandez now in the backfield. Give to Noah. Last time they had third and short, he went 37. This time he gets about seven, good for a first down.
And it was good penetration by Norman, but it's just Noah Hernandez finding the holes in the backfield. He does a nice job of sidestepping the pressure. Look at this side, breaks a couple tackles, and then gets up the field and gets enough for the first down.
First and 10 as James crosses midfield. Corwin looking, but he covered, and that one nearly got picked off. Corwin.
All the time in the world. Yeah. Good coverage over there on the back end by the secondary. Being able to cover for that long with that amount of time with those receivers that Jenks has, very impressive.
Threw for 189 yards and two touchdowns, but had three interceptions a week ago against Edmond Memorial. But as Coach Riggs told us before the game, not all his fault. Even though the quarterback gets credit for him, tip balls, somebody runs a wrong route, and next thing you know, it goes to the defense. Corwin has a wide open Braden Phipps middle of the field, and that's going to be another Jenks first down.
That's a good job by Corwin, fitting that ball in that window over there.
And we have a flag down back at the line of scrimmage. Ineligible receiver downfield for Jenks.
Ineligible downfield for the red. Second down.
The red would be Jenks, guys, if y'all didn't know that.
Or maroon.
But again, it's a nice job, although they don't get the positive yardage. Good job of fitting that ball in that window. Phipps going up and getting it. Would have been enough for the first down. There is a penalty, and so it drives them back. Let's see what they have this time. Trips closed, tight end over there on the top of your screen.
Give to Cox.
And he gets smacked. Look at that. Number 11 coming up with the big stone right there. Cole Thompson. I can hear that one from up here.
Stone Cole Thompson.
Yes, sir. Look at this. He makes the cutback, and Thompson laying the wood just like they teach you in Little League. Put your shoulder on the ball carrier, young man.
That he did. Thompson, a junior. 6'1", 200 pounds.
That's a good size high school linebacker.
Leading tackler on that Norman team. Came into the game with 41 on the season. Corwin again. That pass is caught by Pitcock.
That's a nice job by Pitcock going down there and getting it. Pitcock picks that one up off the turf for the first down for the Trojan.
Jenks picks up the penalty yards back and gets the first down. It's another Trojan. Corwin's going to keep, has blockers out in front. Taken down inside the 20. What a great kid Ian Corwin is, too. Not only a great football player, but National Honor Society Student Council of the Honor. How about this story? First time in Jenks history they've named a homecoming king. They did it this year, and he won.
And no doubt about it, that's the guy that you want leading your ball club and probably leading your student body as well. That's a great play design as well that they had right there. Two tight ends, they motion off the wing back. Then the tight end over here on this side motions over and leads in the hole. And then you got Shelley leading as well. Two lead blockers on that last play.
There's a handoff and up the middle is Grayson Waters. He got a couple. This is a methodical Jinx. They did this in the back mid-first bank backyard bowl. First time they touched the ball with Union, had a better than 6 minute drive to open the game. Kind of set the tone. This one they've taken the ball to start the second half. And they're working on a 5 minute drive right now. 4-1 again to Waters. Dragging tacklers with him inside the five, and another Jinx first down. It'll be first and goal.
Yeah, Waters does a good job of, he doesn't run the same style that you see Nora Hernandez does. He's more forward-leaning, finding the holes as he goes along, and then getting positive yardage, always falling forward as he.
In two tight end formation for Jinx. 4-1. Flips it to one up, and it is a touchdown to Dylan O'Keefe.
Just a nice little bootleg to O'Keefe, doing a good job showing block, pulling out, and getting the easy touchdown for the Jinx Trojans.
Take another look.
You see him on the top of your screen. He blocks first, then he peels out late. Ian Corwin does a good job finding him, just like you draw it up on the chalkboard.
Nice 5 minute drive by Jinx. And it's 21-6. Trojans on top. You're watching the fourth game of the week on YurView.
You're watching Game Time on YurView. For more in-depth coverage of the top players around, recruiting updates, behind-the-scenes access, and more, check out yourview.com.
Are you looking for a career where you can work anywhere and even travel the world? Do you have a passion to work with people, plan events, or own your own restaurant? Tulsa Tech can help you build a successful career with exciting hospitality programs. Programs like culinary arts, restaurant and lodging management, and event planning. Make your own path to a successful career you love by calling Tulsa Tech at 918-828-5000 or apply online at tulsatech.edu.
Game Time Keys to the Game are brought to you by Tulsa Tech. For your future success, go to tulsatech.edu. Join us all fall long for some of the top high school football from around the country on Game Time.
We are back in Jinx. Dion's got some hair like that. He's going to dress like that for Halloween.
No, I'm not.
You sure? You're not going to wear that?
I'm
big
good.
Big wig?
I'm good.
Or the purple. How about the purple cowboy hat?
I think I got some. Although I
you
am.
You look good in that. Come on.
Although I am a cowboy, you know, Oklahoma State Cowboy, so my hats are orange.
Gunnar Luna standing deep. Ethan Bernard, who's perfect on his PATs tonight, puts a toe into it. It's going to be Luna taking it at the five. Big hole right side. Still on his feet. After about the 43, a nice return from the Norman special teams and Gunnar Luna.
Yeah, both of these kickoff return units have had great returns and good field position for the offense. Take a look at this one. It hangs in the air, but it gets there in time for him to have a nice return. A nice block over here on the left side. It runs into his player real quick, but good job by the kicker getting in his way and making the tackle. Two tackles for the kicker.
You said it, getting in his way. So his teammate could make the tackle.
He falls on him late. It still counts.
Most kickers like to tackle. They need to show their worth out there on the football field. Xavier Smith. Big run for him on first down into Jinx territory just like that.
Nice hard run. Let's see it continue. Put a drive together, Norman. Let's go. Take out this run over here right off the left side of the left tackle.
Horton going to keep this time. He gets about four or five. Before he stood up.
Nice little QB power, kind of finding the numbers there, getting an extra blocker from the running back, and they're able to get, looks like about 5 yards. Adjustments being made right now. Horton communicates to the offensive line.
Smith again. No, Horton keeps. He slides, going to be about a yard shy of the first down.
He's really effective with those slides. Not going to lie, I'm thoroughly impressed the way he just swiftly, smoothly gets down on the ground. See if he can swiftly and smoothly get this first down right here.
He does have the first and more. It's down at about the 25. So
you can see he's finding his rhythm. He's getting a little comfortable running the football. And then with that comfortability and the confidence he's growing in the run game, but surely he'll find that in the passing game. And next thing you know, the Tigers will be having a lot of success offensively.
Smith bounces off his own man. It was pushed into the backfield and just runs into a wall of Jenks defenders after that. Matthew Minix
comes up and makes a good stone hit on the offensive player that's trying to block him and accidentally blocks him into his own offensive player, Xavier, over there trying to run the football. Makes it a tackle for loss for this Jenks defense.
Horton just a little bit out of the reach of Payton that time.
And it's just a little outside of his range. A nice little double move on the outside there. He had a beat on the cornerback. Look at this play action pass here. It's just right out of his outstretched arms.
Third and 12. Horton rolling out and incomplete, intended on that right side, and the pass broken up by Caleb Peters.
And that's a great, great play by Caleb Peters, right on time. Look at this play over here. Right as he's trying to get the ball, he makes the tackle and bats the ball away. Good job by Mr. Peters on the outside. Playing tough. They've been going at him a lot tonight because he's been the single receiver side with the cornerbacks on those trips with single receiver. So he's going to be looking at a lot of passes tonight. Let's see if he can have a big night for these Trojans.
Intended for Gabe Ferguson of Norman's. Fourth down and 12. Horton again. And for Payton. Incomplete.
And they go to the same direction, same formation. Trips with a single receiver on the outside. They run the post route. It's open, but Horton just short hops it just a little bit. Look at it, dives at his feet. He has the positioning that he needs. He has Peters on his upfield shoulder. They just can't get the ball there.
So at the end of that, Jonah Payton throwing his arms up, a little bit of frustration. Take a look at the district. Jenks currently in third. Santa Fe, because they won last night, so they're a half game in front at 4-1. Broken Arrow, though, definitely the best team in the state. With a 5-0 record, Jenks calls a timeout here. But BA, Santa Fe, Jenks, Westmore. There you see Norman at 2-2, so definitely must-win time for them. I mean, they could still lose tonight, Dion, but have an opportunity to win out and make the playoffs. Jenks will play Santa Fe next week, so that game will definitely decide
second place.
In the district if everything holds up like it is tonight right now.
And that should be a good matchup because Edmond Santa Fe looks pretty good over there on the west side. Trace Ford over there playing a little tight end and slot receiver and also still at his defensive end position, causing havoc over there in all those opposing teams' backfield.
Santa Fe's only loss was to Broken Arrow.
Lucky fan program, you might have a chance to kick a field goal with that gift card.
Tigers are just laying the lumber to everybody. Keith Riggs. Enjoyed talking to him before the game. Great hospitality, too, here at Jenks, huh?
Definitely.
Nice pregame meal we had, courtesy of our friends over at Burnco.
I had a big plate, and did I enjoy it.
Yes, you did. Corwin tries the up-and-out route to Pitcock, but it's incomplete.
And that's a good job by the corner over there on the outside. We talk about this a lot. Most of the time, as a quarterback, or as a receiver, they try to keep you inside those numbers right there to give some room for the quarterback to throw the football on that upfield shoulder. Right here, the quarterback presses him to the sideline, so there's nowhere for Corwin to fit the football in. And you see, it's out of bounds and out of the outstretched arms of the wide receiver.
Second down.
And that's good.
And good. Yeah, Waters.
Yeah, good patient running by Waters out there on the outside. Staying behind his big blockers and just getting what they give him.
It's going to be third and short for Jenks. Waters in the backfield. He's going to take it. He's got the first. And more. Crosses the 45 to the 47. 11-yard carry. Third and short for Grayson Waters. Another look at it. He's got a little bit of a crease. Breaks a couple of tackles. And gets the first down. Dion is headed down to the field, so we'll get his analysis the last couple of minutes, and then he'll talk to Keith Riggs going into the locker room at the half as Jenks has a 15-point lead. Corwin again, pass caught. It's Julian Clark. Gain of 8. So give him 9, gain of 9, so it's going to be a 2nd and 1. Go before the half. Waters again, trying to get outside and nowhere for him to go. And nice defense by the Norman Tigers. Tyron Robb, number 7, also involved Sam Wishin. Take another look as Waters trying to bounce it out. Actually, it was number 22, Jackson Caldwell, not 32. They made the tackle that time for the Norman Tigers. Third and short again. Waters, first down. After the 31. Another first down for Jenks, their 9th here in the first half. Martin talking to his coaches saying, how do we slow this offense down? They're chewing up clock and chewing up yards here in the second quarter. Corwin again. Deep down to Braden Phipps and a little bit too high for the senior receiver. This is Jake's 2nd possession here in quarter number 2. Norman has touched the ball 1 time. They had a nice drive going before it stalled out. And you take a look at Corwin with the pass.
Thank you, sir.
Sounds like Dion is now on the mic. How's the weather out there?
It feels good, Zig.
Does it?
Exactly what we said in the open. Yep. Feels like football weather.
Did you do a full sprint to get down there?
Yeah, you can hear. I'm not out of breath. I've been training, so.
That's good. Corwin keeps on 2nd down. plenty of room for the senior to run, and he gets down another first down. They're going to mark him down at the 13. Deion, how about this run?
Yeah, that's a good, strong run by Corwin. I kind of get the feeling that he was a little jealous of Horton being able to run those quarterback powers over there on the other side for Norman. So he's decided to show him that he can do it too.
Corwin puts Shelley in motion, gives it off to Hernandez. Hernandez down to the 10. Jenks in no hurry. They've got a minute. They've got two timeouts. See, Hernandez just waits for the hole to open up and then cuts it up inside. Got three on first down. Second and 7. Nice snap. Corwin going to keep, circle around. Here's Keith Riggs yelling for a timeout with 36 seconds to go in the first half.
Yeah, and you can kind of see that the Jenks runners have the luxury of this big, aggressive offensive line of Jenks, and they do a good job of following those blockers. Other than that last play of the high snap, this offensive line has been doing a great job in this first half.
Yeah, be sure to join us for the Giga Blast halftime show. We'll have the Trojan Pride marching band, first half highlights, stats, and more. That's coming up at the half. The Giga Blast halftime show right here on YurView, the Ford game of the week. Giga Blast from Cox. You don't know what you're missing out on if you don't have Giga Blast. I think Giga Blast is almost as fast as you are, Dion.
You know, I try. That was my motivation tonight. I was like, you know what? If I was Giga Blast, how fast would I run down these stairs?
Yeah.
And I just used that to my advantage, and I ran down them pretty fast.
Maybe you should have taken the Giga Blast to get downstairs.
You know what? I'm going to put that Giga Blast in my back pocket next time.
There you go.
We still got another race. We still got another race after this, Zig.
Third and 10. Jenks does have another timeout with 36 seconds to go in the second quarter. Flag, and they're going to call.
And I think Coach Rocky Martin called that all the way from his sideline.
Dark, dead ball, 5-yard penalty against the red.
And there you see Robert Breedlove. You know, Deion, I was telling you about him. He's been a longtime doctor in the state. This is his 52nd year of football, and he's retiring after this year.
Did you say 52nd?
52nd year to be a referee.
Golly.
How about that? Just a great guy and does a great job. And, I mean, look how much he's given back and helped high school football in the state of Oklahoma for 52 years. Corwin over the middle for Julian Clark.
And that's a good job by the defensive back over there, number 21, staying on his back, upfield shoulder, poking his hands in there late, just giving him a little bit of distraction before he can bring that one in for the touchdown.
It's Cortarius Smith.
You know, Zig, I'm trying to do the math over here on the sideline.
Yeah.
I'm 26 years old, okay? And yep. So if we do 26 times 2.
That's 52.
That's 52. This guy has been covering football for twice the time I've been alive.
Field goal try is no good. It's wide to the left. Yeah, how about that? That's just football. He's refereed high school football for 52 years. Like, you've only been alive for 26.
Two of my lifetimes.
Yeah.
Goodness, that's a lot of football.
Yes, it is. Trojan fans, look for the Army's end, your program tonight. Probably close to 600 games he's done. 27297. Still spry and moves around out there like he's all in his 30s, doesn't he?
Sure does.
27 seconds to go in the half.
Mind over matter.
Yep. Ford hands it off to Joe Willie. And he's dropped down at about the 31. It's a first down, but the clock's going to run as soon as they put the ball in play. May want to head to the locker room. They'll be pretty happy with this first half, down just 15. Does not look like they are going to run another play, and yep, that is what it's going to be. So first half's going to come to the end here in Jenks on the Ford game of the week. Trojans, thanks to Noah Hernandez, two touchdowns and then an even poor one pass to Dylan O'Keefe, has a 21-6 lead over the Norman Tigers. Senior night, Jenks up 15. Dion with Coach Riggs.
Coach, I know you're not happy about that last possession, but I mean, other than that, it was good, strong first half performance. What'd you think of it?
Good first half. I'd like to finish that drive, you know, to end the half, but you know, a few mistakes. It's tough to overcome, especially in the red zone. But we'll make some adjustments at halftime and come back out and get after it.
Right. Good luck in the second half, Coach.
Thank you.
And now here's the Jenks Palm Squad.
Say, do you love me? I tell her only partly. I only love my bed and my mom. I'm sorry.
Now, I like dollars, I like diamonds, I like stunning, I like shining, I like million-dollar deals. Where's my pen? Chop sun. I like those Balenciagas, the ones that look like socks. I like going to the jeweler. I put rocks all in my watch. Can't do tripping, can't do tripping, can't do tripping, diamonds on my wrist, they tripping.
All right, it's the Giga Blast halftime show. Jenks on top, 21-6. The Trojan marching band, the Pride, coming up next.
The Giga Blast halftime show, powered by Cox, is brought to you by your Oklahoma Ford dealers, the best in Oklahoma. AirCo, the company you know. Tulsa Tech, for your future success, go to tulsatech.edu. And by Weoki Credit Union. Join us all fall long for some of the top high school football from around the country on Game Time.
Good morning, Bella.
Good morning.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
Bye, little monkeys.
Yay, Bella.
Hold still. Almost done.
Cool. Oh, Bella, I really, really love playing with you.
Thanks, Grandma. I really like our visits.
Whatever tech tomorrow dreams up, you'll be ready with Giga Blast. Future speed internet is here from Cox.
During Ford SUV season, find out why more people come back to Ford than any other brand. Here's a reason.
We've got room.
And here's another.
Waze says it's faster to take the side streets.
Perfect.
And by the way, Ford has won more J.D. Power initial quality awards than any other brand. During Ford SUV season, get 0% for 72 months plus 1,000 bonus cash on Escape, Edge, and Explorer. See your Oklahoma Ford dealer today.
Hey, high school football fans, you want your school to get that VIP treatment? Here's your chance. You choose which game will be the Ford Game of the Week November 1st. Here are your choices. Jenks at Westmore, Edmond North at Union, or Enid at Broken Arrow. To vote, go to yourview.com/FordFanPick. Vote early, vote often, and tell your friends. You vote, you decide. Winners will be announced October 24th. For more information and the best in high school football, go to yourview.com.
You're watching Game Time on YurView. For more in-depth coverage of the top players around, recruiting updates, behind-the-scenes access, and more, check out yourview.com.
We are back on Your View. It is the Ford game of the week. The Trojan Pride marching band still getting things together as they get ready for their halftime performance. It is senior night here in Jenks, final regular season home game of the year for the Trojans. 25 seniors in all for Jenks.
Escorted by
all those
his
players
Brian
you see right there, number three, Noah Hernandez.
Escorted by his parents, James
well
and Crystal
Jacob
Finch.
Shelley for
and his
Jenks.
Grandmother, Cheryl Holtz, and his brother. Escorted by his parents,
and Ian
Byron
Corwin,
and
the quarterback,
Corwin
all-time
brothers,
leading
Logan
passing
Landon
quarterback
Corwin.
In the history of Jenks
Ian
football.
Ian the third.
Jenks' last state title,
escorted
2015.
Parents, Grayson,
these young men
the
were
second,
freshmen,
and Melinda Grace,
and they're trying
Stolansky.
To break a three-year string
escorted
of not winning
parent,
a state championship
John
here in Jenks.
Brady Latham.
Here in 2018, Brady Latham is headed to the University of Arkansas out there with his family on senior night. This is the Giga Blast halftime show, the Trojan Pride marching band. Director Scott Hillock. The performance tonight.
Next week, the Trojan Pride will be performing at the OSSAA State Marching Contest in Tahlequah, then traveling to St. Louis, Missouri for the Bands of America Super Regional Championship next weekend. They will conclude their season at the Bands of America Grand National Championship at Lucas Oil Stadium in Indianapolis. Jenks, Trojan Pride.
The Trojan Pride Marching Band on the Giga Blast Halftime Show getting ready for their national performance. It's 21-6, Jenks at the half. Highlights, stats coming up.
Look, if you're not the lead dog, the scenery never changes. That's why this is the view for every other full-size pickup. And this year, it's deja vu all over again. Because only the Ford F-150 gives you best-in-class torque, best-in-class payload, and you got it, baby, best-in-class towing. This is the big dog. This is the Ford F-150. It doesn't just raise the bar, pal. It is the bar.
Now get 0% financing for 60 months plus $4,250 cash back on a new F-150 at your Oklahoma Ford dealer today.
Hey, high school football fans, you want your school to get that VIP treatment? Here's your chance. You choose which game will be the Ford Game of the Week November 1st. Here are your choices. Jenks at Westmore, Edmond North at Union, or Enid at Broken Arrow. To vote, go to yourview.com/FordFanPick. Vote early, vote often, and tell your friends. You vote, you decide. Winners will be announced October 24th. For more information and the best in high school football, go to yourview.com.
Weoki's new money certificate rates are incredible. Transfer money from another institution to a Weoki 35-month certificate and receive 3.05 APY. Yes, that's over 3%. And get a $100 cash bonus for new CD amounts of $100,000 and greater. Open your certificate with new money at Weoki and start earning incredible rates. Federally insured, rate and bonus are for new money only. Other terms and limitations apply. Contact Weoki for details.
It's that time of year to get your furnace checked.
That's right, and our trouble-free guarantee makes it easy.
If your furnace breaks down this season, this tune-up's on us. Call Airco Service today.
The official service company of the Thunder.
When Oklahoma weather causes the power to go out, you can be left in the dark.
Keep your lights on and your furnace running thanks to a new whole home generator installed by Airco.
And right now, save big on a new Kohler system. Call Airco Service today.
The company you know.
You're watching Game Time on YurView. For more in-depth coverage of the top players around, recruiting updates, behind-the-scenes access, and more, check out yourview.com.
Halftime senior night in Jenks at Allan Trimble Stadium. It's the Ford Game of the Week. Jenks on top 21-6 over Norman. Let's check out the first half highlights between these two teams. Jenks turned it over. First time they touched the ball, Norman responds, gets a field goal. And they are quickly up 3-0 off the foot of Grady Wade. Second time Jenks has the ball, it's Noah Hernandez. 37-yard touchdown run, 45-yard drive. Took him just two plays. And Jenks went on top 7-3. They get the ball back, 35-yard run. Third and short for Hernandez, 14-3 Jenks. Took him four plays to go 57 yards. Norman would add another field goal. That made it 14-6. Second quarter, Jenks touched the ball twice, Norman once. Ian Corwin, second two-yard TD pass to Dylan O'Keefe. 21-6 Jenks at that point. And that's where we sit right now. I said Norman touched it once. They actually touched it twice. They got it with about 30 seconds to go in the half. Basically ran the clock out. Jenks on top. It's the Ford Game of the Week, your Giga Blast Halftime Show.
You guys ready?
This is the Nelson family.
Wi-Fi's good.
And their panoramic Wi-Fi from Cox.
Connected here.
They're helping us demonstrate the speed and coverage of its super fast signal.
Here it comes!
It covers every device and every inch of their home.
He's coming back up!
And with extenders, every room is connected. Cover every corner of your home with super-fast panoramic Wi-Fi from Cox.
During Ford SUV season, find out why more people come back to Ford than any other brand. Here's a reason.
We've got room.
And here's another.
Waze says it's faster to take the side streets.
Perfect.
And by the way, Ford has won more J.D. Power Initial Quality Awards than any other brand. During Ford SUV season, get 0% for 72 months plus 1,000 bonus cash on Escape, Edge, and Explorer. See your Oklahoma Ford dealer today.
You may have heard of Tulsa Tech, But did you know we offer business and industry training for large and small companies? Come get trained and certified in areas like confined space, Hazwoper, crane rigging, CPR, first responder, and more. To learn more about our affordable and customized training and how Tulsa Tech can be a valuable resource to your company, call 918-828-5000 or visit us online at tulsatech.edu.
Weoki's new money certificate rates are incredible. Transfer money from another institution to a Weoki 35-month certificate and receive 3.05 APY. Yes, that's over 3%. And get a $100 cash bonus for new CD amounts of $100,000 and greater. Open your certificate with new money at Weoki and start earning incredible rates. Federally insured, rate and bonus are for new money only. Other terms and limitations apply. Contact Weoki for details.
6, Jenks with the lead. Take a look at the first half stats. Jenks tearing it up on the ground. 180 yards total rushing. Norman's got 85. Total offense, 230 to 156. First downs pretty even, 10 to 8. And one turnover in the game. That was on Jenks on their first possession of the game, first play of the game for their offense. Scored 14 in the first and 7 in the second. They are up 21-6. Giga Blast Halftime Show, second half, kickoff coming up next.
Look, if you're not the lead dog, the scenery never changes. That's why this is the view for every other full-size pickup. And this year, it's deja vu all over again. Because only the Ford F-150 gives you best-in-class torque, best-in-class payload, and you got it, baby, best-in-class towing. This is the big dog. This is the Ford F-150. It doesn't just raise the bar, pal. It is the bar.
Now get 0% financing for 60 months plus $4,250 cash back on a new F-150 at your Oklahoma Ford dealer today.
Hey, high school football fans, you want your school to get that VIP treatment? Here's your chance. You choose which game will be the Ford Game of the Week November 1st. Here are your choices. Jenks at Westmore, Edmond North at Union, or Enid at Broken Arrow. To vote, go to yourview.com/FordFanPick. Vote early, vote often, and tell your friends. You vote, you decide. Winners will be announced October 24th. For more information and the best in high school football, go to yourview.com.
Weoki's new money certificate rates are incredible. Transfer money from another institution to a Weoki 35-month certificate and receive 3.05 APY. Yes, that's over 3%. And get a $100 cash bonus for new CD amounts of $100,000 and greater. Open your certificate with new money at Weoki and start earning incredible rates. Federally insured, rate and bonus are for new money only. Other terms and limitations apply. Contact Weoki for details.
It's that time of year to get your furnace checked.
That's right, and our trouble-free guarantee makes it easy.
If your furnace breaks down this season, this tune-up's on us. So call Erico Service today.
The company you know.
When Oklahoma weather causes the power to go out, you can be left in the dark.
Keep your lights on and your furnace running thanks to a new whole home generator installed by Erico.
And right now, save big on a new Kohler system. Call Erico Service today.
The company you know.
You're watching Game Time on YurView. For more in-depth coverage of the top players around, recruiting updates, behind-the-scenes access, and more, check out yourview.com.
It's 21-6. Our scores, we get ready to start the third quarter. Norman will kick off the Jenks. The Trojans won the coin toss to start the game. They deferred, so that means they get the ball to start half number two. Deion Amati has sprinted up the stairs, four flights to get here to the top of the press box in time for the second half kickoff.
It's nothing.
It's nothing? No, you're not even breathing hard. That's good. I'm
it's
proud
nothing,
of you.
It's nothing, you know?
How about that second quarter? Jenks had the ball twice. I said Norman had it once. I mean, they had it twice, but they basically ran out the clock in the final 30 seconds, so it does count as a drive, but they didn't really have an opportunity to do a whole lot with the football. They marched, but then their drive stalled out.
Yeah, good. I mean, first of all, it was a good job keeping the ball and time of possession for Jenks. For Norman, it's kind of situations where you're getting three and outs and inopportune things are happening on these offensive drives from them for them to turn to get the ball right back to Jenks. So they got to figure out a way to do some things that allows this offense to have some success. Was able to talk to some of the coaching staff inside the elevator for Norman, and they were like, we got to do the little things right. We have to do the little things right.
Now you just admitted you rode the elevator. Way to go. I thought you sprinted up the stairs.
No, I sprinted up the stairs, and then for the left floor, the door was closed. I had to get on the elevator. You see how that happens?
Yeah, okay, I got
you. Yeah, I didn't ride the elevator the whole way up. Come on now.
How about the keys to the game? While you were on the elevator, they brought these back up in the truck and said, Deion, tell us what about those keys of the game.
Well, the keys for the game, okay, number one, you got to sustain some drives. Cruising or bruising, you got to cruise through this thing, sustain some drives, pick up some first downs, and have a good series. Number two, don't give it away. No turnovers. We saw one turnover for Jenks in that first time they touched the ball. They've been good so far.
Out of bounds kick, re-kick.
And number three, keep it small. When I say keep it small, I mean do not allow any big plays. They have two touchdowns that were pretty much explosive plays for Jenks. You can't allow that to continue to happen. You got to keep them in short yardage.
Well, they did a good job keeping them in short yardage because both touchdowns, Jenks was at 3rd and 2. And then they busted it for a 37 and 35-yard touchdown run.
When you keep them in short yardage, you got to make sure you
keep
stop them.
You got to keep them in short yardage.
Stop them.
Emphasize on the keep them. Well, they kicked the ball out of bounds, and instead of just taking the penalty, I thought they could take the penalty yards, but they're going to make Norman kick it again.
Well, I mean, as well as they've been returning the ball tonight, you might as well go and get another opportunity at it.
Braden Phipps one more time. Has some room, tries to get outside. Taken down at about the 37.
Think it was a good decision, Zip?
That's about where they would have got it.
No harm, no foul.
Yep. I guess it gives you a chance to work on your special teams, right?
Practice makes perfect.
Start from the 37-yard line. First series of half number two. One touchdown in that second quarter. Jenks missed a field goal and pass complete from Corwin to Braden Phipps. And that's how we start the second half. Corwin on the night passing the football for Jenks.
That's a good tackle. Good.
He's done a nice job.
Yeah, that's a good open field tackle by number 17, Cedric Seals. 5 yard out, does a good job of keeping them from getting the first down on first down. See what they can do here on second.
Second short, Corwin. Looking for Pitcock, makes a nice catch.
That is a great catch by Pitcock. And it was a good job by the defensive back, number two for the Norman Tigers. Gunnar Luna comes up, makes a nice break on the football. I thought Ian Corwin might have made a mistake here, but good job by Pitcock making the strong catch. Making sure Luna was all right down there and letting him know that he caught the football as well.
So a first down for Jenks, their 11th of the game. Get to Waters, and he slips right as he tries to cut at the line of scrimmage.
That's good penetration by the defensive lineman, number 45, Tevin Randall, coming up and making the stop as Waters slips and falls in the backfield. So thought it might have been a tackle for loss, but it seems like Waters does enough to get to the line of scrimmage.
Waters, a move in from Texas, played quarterback down in Texas at a 3A school down there. Spending his senior year here in Jenks. Julian Clark on the catch from Corwin, and a nice gain of 8. Maybe 7. 7.5.
Looks like they're going away from the tendency right here. You can see it's been 12 personnel for the most part of this drive where you see one back and two tight ends. They've been running the football when they've shown that formation for the most part, but this time they just raise up and throw a quick screen pass, which essentially is another running play for the wide receiver, but it's a pass, so they get to the outside, trying to break up the tendencies here.
Two tight ends for the Trojans, two receivers to the left. Corwin fakes the pass, throws it, and then hits Pitcock, and then a flag comes flying in. I wonder if maybe there was linemen downfield.
That's exactly what I was thinking, too. Kind of seemed like a miscommunication over there from the wide receiver and the quarterback. It looked like he wanted to hit him on that five-yard hitch route to the inside receiver.
And it was covered up.
Ineligibles downfield. Red.
Robert Breedlove, you know he says ineligibles. He didn't say ineligible receiver, but ineligibles, that means
that's plural, huh?
Probably three, four, five of those offensive linemen were downfield.
Multiple guys.
Multiple guys. So back it up five, and it'll be still third down for Jenks. Third and about seven. Corwin, the senior, wide open. Braden Phipps, I think his knee was down. You can see why. Corwin came in as the all-time passing leader, 7,414 yards, 69 career TDs. He's now got 70. But you can see why. Look at that throw.
Watch him thread that needle right there. Just a nice tight spiral. Hits the receiver right in the chest, right inside that window, and you can see on that replay his knee does go down, so therefore this is not the NFL. You can't put your knee down and not be touched by anybody and continue running, so he is down right there, but it's enough for the first down.
He passed Cooper Nunley last week, the former Jenks quarterback. Hernandez, are you kidding me? Is he going to do it again? Yes, he is, this time from 27 yards out. Noah Hernandez, they like that run off the guard, and there's just open space.
And Noah Hernandez has made the decision in his mind. He is not going to be denied on his senior night. There's a three on his jersey, and he has three touchdowns tonight. Good job, Noah Hernandez. And the offensive line of Jenks is doing a stupendous job.
116 yards on the night for Hernandez after that 27-yard touchdown. Also his third TD of the night. Jenks comfortably ahead here with 9 minutes to go in the third. It's 28-6. Man, you just love to watch this young man run. Look at this. Big. Look at the blocking
look
up front.
Look at the blocking, yeah. Zig. You can see Jacob Shelley over there picking up a guy over there to help Noah Hernandez bring loose. And then the last second, somebody tries to bring him down over there on the two-yard line. And Noah Hernandez says no. Shows off the strength and takes it into the end zone.
Great job by the offensive lineman up front for Jenks. Max Johnson, John Roberts, Hunter Hoyt, Brady Latham, Carter Brestovansky. This guy's blocking away, and then as Dion mentioned, you saw that look from behind. Jacob Shelley made a nice kick-out block as well. And it's definitely a team effort that we have. The guy scoring gets the credit, but it's the five to seven guys in front of him that are making the blocks.
And especially when he goes in and he's untouched until he reaches to the two-yard line, you know it was a group effort by that offense to get him into that end zone.
Almost a three-minute drive for Jenks to get down and score and put more points on the board. Kick goes into the end zone. Dion, how about this last scoring by drive by Jenks? It was a mix of Ian Corwin passing and the running of Noah Hernandez.
Yeah, look, first look at that strong catch by Pitcock over there. Very contested. Does a good job of coming down with it. Then the nice screen, the screen pass to the outside to get up there and get the first down. And then Noah Hernandez, three on the back of his jersey, three touchdowns tonight. It's not even over.
Six plays, 83 yards. First down, Joe Willie. A nice run for the Norman Tigers.
Joe Willie, the guy that we featured tonight with the big run of his own. Look at this. Sees the hole. Nice cut over there off the offensive lineman, number 75, picking up a great block. Good job hugging it out to the football as well.
Tristan Quillen pulls him down, but not after he got 27. Horton slipped as he tried to cut upfield at the 45.
Yeah, and we mentioned that it's not raining right now, but it did rain all over Tulsa.
Most of the night, this morning.
So the field is a little slippery.
Second down, Horton. That's it. About third or fourth time they've run that same route where the receiver comes in and curls.
The pivot route right there is a nice little, normally you see it a lot in the goal line or short yardage downs. It's hard to defend. They're doing it a lot in the open field and especially in that boundary over there.
Andrew Young with another catch.
Andrew Young having a good night tonight.
Horton keeps. He's got a first down and finally pulled down, but he's into Jenks territory.
And you can see this team is finding a little routine and finding a little rhythm. The zone read play right there, doing a good job seeing his key and taking it right up the gut to get the first down for the Tigers.
10th first down of the night for Norman. Horton gives it off to Joe Willie. Run by him.
And it's a good job by the offensive line getting up the field and creating the hole. You knew it was going to be something happening to this boundary side when you saw the receiver splitting out, trying to draw that linebacker out a little bit to widen that gap.
Horton keeps it again. Zone read, and he's down to the 10. Five. Touchdown, Cade Horton.
And that's the way you put together a drive, Tigers. Doing a good job running, passing. Then the zone read, he sees the alley, he finds the sideline, gets up, and gets into the end zone. Touchdown, Tigers. Look at this one more time. Zone read, they've been doing it this whole drive. He finds the sideline, sees it, and uses the speed to get up into the end zone. And he doesn't even need the slide for this first base steal.
PAT is good. Touchdown on the board. 26-yard touchdown run by Cade Horton. 28-10, our score here in Jenks, 13.
During Ford SUV season, find out why more people come back to Ford than any other brand. Here's a reason.
We've got room.
And here's another.
Waze says it's faster to take the side streets.
Perfect.
And by the way, Ford has won more J.D. Power Initial Quality Awards than any other brand. During Ford SUV season, get 0% for 72 months plus 1,000 bonus cash on Escape, Edge, and Explorer. See your Oklahoma Ford dealer today.
Are you looking for a career where you can work anywhere and even travel the world? Do you have a passion to work with people, plan events, or own your own restaurant? Tulsa Tech can help you build a successful career with exciting hospitality programs. Programs like culinary arts, restaurant and lodging management, and event planning. Make your own path to a successful career you love by calling Tulsa Tech at 918-828-5000 or apply online at tulsatech.edu.
Five plays, 80 yards. It's 28-13. I don't know where I got 10 from since they had six. Six plus seven is always 13, but 28-13, 7:31 to go.
Is it always 13?
Yeah, five plays, 80 yards. Last time I checked, seven plus six is 13. Rocky Martin's got to be happy with that.
Yeah, that was a good drive for this Norman Tigers team. That was something that they needed to see out of halftime, see if they can continue having some more success offensively.
Good mix. They obviously saw something because that quarterback RPO where Horton was keeping it was very successful on that. Brady Wade kicks it off. Noah Hernandez at about the 24. And he's got some room. No, they pull him down right around the 40.
And you got to give it up for Brandon Henry right there on that tackle. He stayed on. But look at the scoring drive right here. A bunch of zone reads. You can see that one for a first down by Horton. He does a good job getting up the field, and he's looking what they're reading. That time they give, Joe Willie gets up and gets a first down for himself. And this time, a nice zone read, hole wide open. He finds the sideline, shows off the speed, and gets in, and he's safe.
Stepping around the tag at home to score. 11 times he's rushed the ball tonight for 80 yards, so a good rushing night for Cade Horton. Jenks, see if they can respond. Corwin, pitch and go. Julian Clark, pass complete, carrying a defender with him inside the 10-yard line.
And it was just a nice double move by number 81. Look at this right here. Stride for stride, doesn't break concentration, tracks down the ball and brings it in. Good job by Julian Clark.
53 yards on the pickup as Corwin goes to Clark.
You see him, he hit him with the pump fake, a little bit of a bite by the corner, and that's why he was a little bit behind Clark, and Clark was able to bring it in.
Inside the red zone again, and this time they give to Jacob Shelley and two Norman defenders there to make the tackle. Cole Thompson, the leading tackler on this team, one of them.
Yeah, does a good job seeing the hole, goes through it and fills it nicely and brings down Shelley from behind.
Now second goal for Jenks.
It's going to be interesting to see if they can kind of get a stop here in the red zone. Right now you're telling your defense just asking for them to stop them here and ask for 3 points.
Wide open O'Keefe. No, not O'Keefe. It's number 87. Rolling his way into the end zone and scoring the touchdown, Bo Estes.
Bo Estes. Bo knows. Look at that strong, determined run after the catch to get into the end zone. Spinning, tearing away tacklers, and finally reaching over for the Jenks Trojan touchdown. Take a look at the replay. Just a nice bootleg. He's all by himself. Tacklers coming at his legs. Not enough arm tackles here and there. He rips his arm away, stretches the ball across the goal line, and in for the touchdown.
Estes, a junior. That PAT is good, so Jenks responds in three plays. Gets the 22-point lead back just like that.
Just like that. Very impressive drive for Norman, and a very impressive way to answer back for Jenks.
Took them less than a minute to march down the field and score. Take a look again.
Nice, simple bootleg. Open tight end over here on the 5-yard out. Coming across, and he just rips the defender away. It's just a determined run, Zig.
Nice job hanging on to the ball, too, as the defender tried to strip it away as he was spinning.
Bo knows where the goal line is.
Bo knows. Don't forget, next Thursday, the fourth game of the week, we're going to be over in Edmond. Edmond Memorial will be hosting number one ranked and undefeated Broken Arrow. If you haven't had a chance to see this Tiger football team, you might want to check it out. That's next Thursday night, 7 o'clock on YurView. BA 8-0, first time since 1997 they've been 8-0 in a season. And that is next Thursday, Cox Channel 3. Edmond Memorial hosting number one ranked and undefeated Broken Arrow. Tigers ending the season, I think, four consecutive weeks that we'll be playing on a Thursday night. This is our Ford fan pick game of the week tonight. Fans, you the fans, pick this one. Coming up in a couple of weeks, we'll have another one. Very quick scoring drive, three plays. More than 60 yards, 61 yards, and ended up with Ian Coleman throwing the touchdown pass to Bo Edmonds, and that made it 35-13. The last four times these teams have met, Deion, Jenks has scored at least 50 points. They are on pace to do that again tonight. They scored 51, 63, 55, and 58.
Right there, good job by Matthew Mannix, coming from his linebacker spot, kind of stoning the hole. Nowhere to go for Joe Willie in the backfield.
Horton on second down, pass complete. To number eight for Norman, Dalen Richard.
That was a good job on the corner route right there. Good ball location as well for Horton, putting it right in the belly of his wide receiver so he doesn't have to take the big hit from the safety coming over the top.
First down, 11th of the night for this Norman team. Horton again on the keeper, slips down to about the 35.
Horton seems to be having some tough time with the footing over there with those Under Armour cleats, falling to the ground about three or four times tonight.
That three gave him. Second makes it second seven. Here comes the blitz, and Noah Hernandez comes flying in with a big time sack.
Two guys come scot free as they shift to cover three and send some blitzers on the outside. Matthews and Hernandez both meet there, but Hernandez is the one who gets there first. Look at this.
Loss of nine.
He tries to do a spin move. Good job by Matthew Mixon staying on the outside and keeping contained. Mannix doing a good job staying disciplined, staying on the outside, not allowing the quarterback to weasel his way out.
Joe Willie, he might get the first down, and he does, across midfield and into Jenks territory.
Good run by Willie, finding the outside, getting up into the hole and bursting through. Look at this again, it's a zone read. He gives it this time. Willie does a good job of running through that hole with a certain burst of speed, switching the ball to the outside arm, and then getting out of bounds.
This time, Willie got a couple. Does a nice run after the sack.
I tell you,
good to see Norman respond and get a first down.
I tell you one thing too, this offensive line for Norman is doing a good job putting up a tough fight against this Jenks defensive line. Doing a good job up front in the interior, especially after halftime. I don't know what they told him, but they told him something.
10 rushes, 90 yards. Horton, nowhere to go, scrambles. Fighting to get some yards out of it, but nobody was open.
He's got to be careful with that football too, Zig. You can see that thing flying every which way. That Jenks defense is pretty smart. They're going to poke at it. It's going to come out. Look at it right here. He does a good job seeing that they hit the double move on the outside on the single receiver side, but it's not there because the corner does a good job of staying on top. I think they were in cover three, so he has to stay on top on the outside. He sees he doesn't have anything and tries to get up the field. Be careful with the football, though.
Five, Horton throwing. And
was that a catch?
I don't know. Boy, it looked like it hit the turf from here.
Harvey
Cooper coming up big.
I think that might have been a catch, Dig, and I hope we got a replay because I think he one-arm snagged that from the turf. Look at this. He hits that backside shoulder. Oh, baby, that's a catch.
Okay.
Two hands on the football.
His hands
were completely underneath that. That was a catch, and that was a play.
Joe Willie spun around as he gets down to about the 18. Joe, I don't know. I'd like to take another look at that. I think it hit his hand, but it also hit the turf and bounced up to it.
Look at this right here. His hands are underneath it the whole time. Never touches the ground.
Never touches the ground. Great job by our camera crew.
Woo! Harvey Cooper, you, my man, have some hands. Look at that.
Nice
back grab. Shoulder throw, extends his arm and brings it in. Might be the play of the season.
Nice catch. Horton again. Pass too high as he's looking for Mr. Young. A little extracurricular talking over there. The official steps in and calms things down. Take a look at Harvey Cooper, the senior, 5'10", 165.
I'll tell you right now, Zig, he deserves that one on his chest. That's the number one receiver on the field right now. I'll tell you that right now. Number one in my book.
Third and eight. Watch for the quarterback run again. They've had success with it tonight. They're going to pass. Horton under pressure. Spins away from it. Throws toward the end zone, and there is a flag that comes flying in. We're going to have holding on Jenks, and that's going to be a first down.
And that's a smart play by Horton. I see he was giving his receiver an opportunity at that ball, but he saw how close that defensive back was. He saw that he was draped all over. He gave the referees an opportunity to take a second look at that and call the flag.
You see Robert Breedlove finally turning his microphone on.
Defensive pass interference. It results in a first down, half the distance to go.
Look at this right here. You see, he's just trying to give his wide receiver a chance. He knows he doesn't have that much of a good one, but he sees the DB draped all over him. That's some of the things that you see on the next level. College players, and even further than that, NFL does a good job of that. You don't have nothing, you throw it where your receiver can't, the DB can't get it, but you know your wide receiver probably doesn't have a good shot at it as well. But you have the referees look at the play closer, and they're forced to throw that flag.
It's now first and goal for Norman, just outside the 8-yard line. 35-13 our score. Jenks led it 21-6 at the half. Each team has scored a touchdown here in half number two. Joe Willie, room inside the five, and finally pulled down and tackled to keep him from scoring. Will Cox, number 21 on the tackle. Another one of those Jenks linebackers who doubles up as a running back.
Yeah, they got a couple of them. They do a good job over there on the interior.
Willie again. That time taken down by Travion Sear.
Yeah, good job by big number 52 Sear to get in that backfield, cause some havoc and stop Willie. Almost got loose there, was able to get across that goal line, but he holds on long enough for his teammates to come help him and bring him down. Third down now.
Gordon keeps. Sandwiched and crunched there at about the one. And really, you gotta go for the touchdown here. Field goal doesn't do you much good.
You have to go for it, and you're down 22 points here. And it's...
You're down three scores.
It's 30 seconds left on the clock in the third, late in the third quarter. You gotta get points when you have the opportunity to. They're in the red zone right now. They're going for it.
Gordon keeps it, tripped up in the backfield by Quillen, and he's taken down short of the line of scrimmage.
And I don't know if he fumbled the ball or not, but either way, it's Jenks football. Take a look at the replay right here. Good job by number two right here. He stays outside, he sees that he doesn't give, and he does fumble the football, and Jenks falls on it.
Quillen read that RPO perfectly. fake like he was going for the back. And kept it, he just kept moving.
He just falls off kind of slightly, wraps around the ankles. That's a good athletic play.
Tristan Quillen, a senior. His brother Austin played here at Jenks. So Ian Corwin as Jenks starts at their own 2-yard line. Flag comes flying in as Waters is tackled at about the 2.
Good job by Cole Thompson coming in and making the stop over there.
Probably going to have a hold.
Holding on the red, half the distance on the snap. Under. Oh.
If I'm Norman, I'd decline the penalty because he didn't get anywhere. You don't want to give him an extra down, right?
That's what I would think.
So I'm not sure why they would mark anything off.
And it looks like Rocky Martin is trying to argue that right now.
Jenks isn't going to snap the ball. They're going to let the quarter wind out.
And look how upset he is because he knows he's thinking the same thing as we are.
That is it. Jenks leads at 35-13 as we head to the fourth. It is the Ford game of the week on YurView.
Good morning, Bella.
Good morning.
Are you ready?
Yeah. Bye, little monkey.
Yay, Bella.
Hold still. Almost done.
I really, really love playing with you.
Thanks, Grandma. I really like our visits.
Whatever tech tomorrow dreams up, you'll be ready with Gigablast. Future speed internet is here from Cox.
Look, if you're not the lead dog, the scenery never changes. That's why this is the view for every other full-size pickup. And this year, it's deja vu all over again. Because only the Ford F-150 gives you best-in-class torque, best-in-class payload, and you got it, baby, best-in-class towing. This is the big dog. This is the Ford F-150. It doesn't just raise the bar, pal. It is the bar.
Now get 0% financing for 60 months plus $4,250 cash back on a new F-150 at your Oklahoma Ford dealer today.
Winter's just around the corner, so it's a great time to replace your furnace before you need it most.
A planned replacement can save you thousands of dollars while improving the comfort and efficiency of your home.
Don't get caught in the cold. Call Airco Service today.
The company you know.
No one thinks about their water heater until it fails.
At that point, you have a huge mess on your hands with water damage everywhere.
A planned water heater replacement can save you a lot of trouble.
Right now, you can save big on a new high-efficiency water heater.
Call Airco Service.
The company you know.
Fourth quarter underway in Jenks. First down and 11 as the Trojans lost a yard on that first play with the hold. Drayson Waters on first down picks up a couple. And Deion, Coach Martin was not happy during that quarter change, was he?
Whatsoever. He was very fanatic on the sideline and very enthusiastic, to say the least, talking to those referees over there and trying to plead his case.
And we're not sure. All we can do is assume that he didn't want to take the penalty and say, just, we got the guy at the line of scrimmage, make it second down.
And one thing that this Norman defense has to beware of right here is an offense will take a shot deep in this situation.
Here they go. Corwin throws it out to the right side to Shelley, fighting his way toward the 10. It's going to be a third and short for Jenks.
And you can see they wanted to go deep, but they had it covered up nicely, so good job by the Norman secondary and good job by Luna finding a way to get Shelley to the ground.
Well, Hernandez back there. He gives off to Waters. He cuts up field, and he's going to have a first down. This may be one of those. Jenks drives, they start at their own two. They eat up half the game clock here in the fourth quarter and put this one on ice.
I don't know if that's going to happen or not, but tell you one thing, both of these teams are out here fighting, and I like it. I like it a lot. Norman doing a good job defensively and making Jenks earn everything they get here in this second half.
First down, Waters again.
That's a good tackle by number seven over there. Traven Robb.
12 carries, 64 yards.
Tyron doing a good job bringing him down by his shoulders right here. Good job staying away from the neck area just a little bit. Almost there, but he does a good job staying away from it.
See Waters looking at the ref going, he's grabbing me in the back of the helmet. How's that not something?
Watch out for the play action.
One up top, boy, puts it in a perfect spot where only Blake Pitcock can catch it.
And that is picture.
Oh no, that's Braden Phipps, number four.
That's picture perfect, and that's a great catch. Great catch by Phipps. Look at him drop it in the bucket. Phipps putting his hands out there late in just a fingertip grab. Look at that, one more time. 2 feet down and off into the sideline.
His dad, Paul Phipps, played here at Jenks back in the 90s. Stud linebacker, another one of those linebacker, running back, fullback type. Part of that, one of those state championship teams. And I know his dad, Terry Phipps. Which would be Braden's grandfather. I saw him out here tonight for senior night. Poor one again, up top, flag comes out. We're gonna have pass interference against Norman.
I think that's going to be a holding call.
Pass is intended for senior Matt McCabe. Again, Robert Breedlove, the referee you see there in the white hat. If you didn't hear me in the first half, he is retiring at the end of this season. We'll hear what he has to say. And it's a hold against Norman, so a 10-yard penalty. 52 years this man has been a referee in high school football in the state of Oklahoma.
Defensive holding on the white. First down.
It's a lot of football. 52 years of first downs and pass interferences.
Four one again. The Waters. He's forced out of bounds into Norman territory.
And that's just a good job by this Jenks offense. You see the coverage outside. It's one man. That means one safety is over the top of everything, and it's man across the boards. Well, what do? They swing their running back, who's guarding man-to-man by an outside linebacker, and he gets outside, picks up a good chunk of yards, and it makes it a manageable second down.
Gain of 4 seconds, six. Jenks with trips to the right.
They're sending pressure again.
Corwin again, up top to Pitcock. Incomplete, it'll be a third and six. 9:17 to go in the fourth quarter. See the look, Jenks trying to keep pace with Santa Fe for the district race. David McPherson on the coverage that time for Norman. Santa Fe won last night, so they're 4-1. If Jenks wins this one tonight, they'll be 4-1 in the district. And then the two teams meet next week. The second place on the line. Corwin again, going up top. And another flag comes flying in. We're going to have another interference penalty against Norman.
And right there, that was a good job by Waters being able to pick up the blitz. He stoned that linebacker right in the middle of the gap.
So on a third and six. Another penalty against the Norman defense.
Pass interference against the White, first down.
Gives Jenks another first down. 16 on the night.
Just a little too much contact there early.
Corwin. Flag comes flying in. You're going to have a hold on Jenks as Corwin scrambling all over the place. He's just going to dump him downfield.
And he takes a big hit over there on the sideline by Cole Thompson. Does a good job of finishing the play. Look at this extra effort by Cole. Corwin does a good job of eluding all the pressure in the world. And then Cole puts that face mask into his ribs on the end of that right there.
Corwin lets him know about it.
Yeah, quarterback's the player.
Holding against the red. Still be first down.
Four straight plays where they were passing the ball, which is unusual, especially with the success they've had running it.
Yeah, I mean, sometimes you just get away and get a little pass happy, but they find the way to the running back here over here. Waters gets up the field and picks up about 6 yards. See what they do here on second down is they got a long way to go, 27 yards to be exact.
Again, but that time it's complete.
And you know who it is.
That's number 87 for Jenks is who it is, Bo Estes.
Bo knows Estes. Good, strong catch by Bo, too. Defender gets a hand in there, tries to rip it away, but strong hand.
Now it's third and 10, so they picked up 17 on the last two plays.
Compared to where they were, this is a manageable third down.
Middle to Clark, first down, Jenks to the 15. So just like that, three plays, 27 yards, first down.
And he just puts the ball right on the money there. Just a simple 10-yard in from the wide receiver. Puts it right on his face mask. And good job by Julian Clark bringing the ball in and getting the first down. So they're back in the red zone.
Corwin's going to keep. He's going to score. Ian Corwin on senior night into the end zone, 15-yard touchdown.
And it was easy for Ian Corwin. He checks out the zone read, and they've been giving it on that play so much. The running back almost said, what are you doing? Why are you taking it away from me? But Ian Corwin read the defensive end, saw that he crashed in really hard, bit on the fake, and so he says, oh, I think I got a running lane here. And he takes it in, hops over the goal line, and it's a Jenks Trojan touchdown.
And the PAT is good. Jenks on top, 42-13, 7:09 to go here at Allan Trimble Stadium.
You're watching Game Time on YurView. For more in-depth coverage of the top players around, recruiting updates, behind-the-scenes access, and more, check out YurView.com.
Hey, high school football fans, you want your school to get that VIP treatment? Here's your chance. You choose which game will be the Ford Game of the Week November 1st. Here are your choices. Jenks at Westmore, Edmond North at Union, or Enid at Broken Arrow. To vote, go to yearview.com/FordFanPick. Vote early, vote often, and tell your friends. You vote, you decide. Winners will be announced October 24th. For more information and the best in high school football, go to yearview.com.
You're watching Game Time on YurView. For more in-depth coverage of the top players around, recruiting updates, behind-the-scenes access, and more, check out YurView.com.
Jenks on top. It is senior night, and the seniors have had a big impact on this game. Noah Hernandez, three touchdowns. Ian Corwin, a rushing touchdown and a passing touchdown. To another senior, Dylan O'Keefe. Jenks has 25 seniors on the roster this year. These guys were freshmen when Jenks last won a state championship back in 2015. Trying to get back in the state championship realm again. Nice by Gunnar Luna. Spins away from everybody, and again, the kicker, number 38, Ethan Bernard, a touchdown saving push out of bounds.
And that was an extraordinary effort by Luna. Look at this catch. He finds a hole and then it closes so quickly. So he stutters, he stops, he does a nice stiff arm, loops all the way around, finds a block by number 4 over there on the sideline. And luckily enough for Jenks, the kicker is there to save the day again.
Smith on first down. He got about 5 as he gets up to the 45-yard line. Smith is seniors, but spent time in the backfield with Joe Willie, who's just a junior. And Willie had been starting most of the games, and then when we saw this team a couple of weeks back when they beat Moore, rather when they lost to Moore, Smith got the start. Jenks is calling a timeout, and they've kind of been sharing running back duties, and Coach Martin loves the fact that he's got those two guys to do that.
Fans, the University of Tulsa and Trimble Strong Foundation have partnered together to drive.
See, Coach Martin. How about this week on YurView's High School Football Recruiting Podcast Over the Middle? ESPN's Tom Van Haren joins Jeremy to discuss the impact the NCAA's new transfer and redshirt rules have had on college football recruiting. We've already seen national-level teams like Clemson and Oklahoma State impacted by these changes, but they won't be the last. Jeremy also breaks down the Ford fan pick battle between Carl Albert and Guthrie that was on YurView last Friday night. And he also makes his call on which 5-star quarterback he would want leading his program. All that and more in this week's episode of Over the Middle, a podcast. Check it out at YurView.com. Dion, what do you think about that new rule? If you play in only 4 games, still retain your red shirt.
I think it benefits the players a lot. They're using it to their advantage, and it's always good when the players get a say in what their future looks like. I mean, get out there as a freshman, get some experience, and then if things aren't going your way later on in your career, you're able to transfer and get out and have a better situation in your opinion, better things to help you and your family.
Third short, Smith, first down for Norman. Whenever there's a rule, somebody's always going to find a loophole or a way around it or a way it benefits them. And it did take long because they just put the rule into effect 6 months ago. And Kelly Bryant transferred from Clemson. Jalen McCleskey transferred from Oakland, you know, said, okay, I've played my 4 games, I'm done. I'm using a redshirt year and transferring somewhere else.
Yeah, and honestly, and if it better helps them and it better helps their family and if they think it's the best for them individually, then they should go ahead and do it.
Let's 6:03 to go in this one. It's the Ford game of the Ford game of the week. Jenks comfortably in front.
Hey, high school football fans, you want your school to get that VIP treatment? Here's your chance. You choose which game will be the Ford game of the week November 1st. Here are your choices. Jenks at Westmore, Edmond North at Union, or Enid at Broken Arrow. To vote, go to yourview.com/FordFanPick. Vote early, vote often, and tell your friends. You vote, you decide. Winners will be announced October 24th. For more information and the best in high school football, go to yourview.com.
We're back in action. Important. First down, deep throw, and too far away from Noah Payton.
And that's
Jonah Payton.
That's the second time that he's just out of the outstretched arms of Jonah Payton right there. Number 12 going vertical down the field, has a beat on the wide receiver. Ah, man. You think if he was able to lay out, he could have maybe caught that pass in?
No. Too far. And we had a penalty in the meantime, so Norman.
Pass interference on the defense, 15-yard previous spot, first down.
Picks up a free first down. They move deeper into Jenks territory, closer to the red zone. Xavier Smith cuts back. They're running a counter play, and he picks up about three or four.
Good positive yardage on first down.
Got four, second six. Fourth again, there's that little curl route they've run several times tonight. This time Jenks had it defended.
Yeah, they had a pivot route again for the upteenth time tonight. Good job by Jaden Patrick to jump that route right there. Seen it all night. Finally, he gets a beat on it. Almost makes a play.
Patrick, a sophomore, getting some prime time on this Friday night. Was fall break here in Oklahoma, so kids were out of school Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. Both coaches kind of said, hey, we tried to keep the routine as normal as we could, as Horton is under pressure again. Another flag comes flying in.
He catches that.
Two flags are flying in. I think that Norman had guys, well, offensive linemen, a good 5 or 6 yards downfield.
Well, that's never good.
He had the referee on this side, also threw a flag. So you may end up having, it's either going to be offsetting penalties or something against Norman.
Well, either way, that was still a great catch by Gabe Ferguson over there on the sideline.
Penalties on White. First one is ineligible downfield. Second one is an illegal shift. Both penalties are 5 yards. We'll only take one of them from the previous spot.
He explained that thoroughly. Take another look at this catch over here. Good job eluding the pressure by Horton. Stayed right on the sideline, was inbounds, tapped that 1 foot down, and brought it in. You can see Coach Rocky Martin telling the ref that's a catch. Certainly was, but that was also a penalty.
Horton's pass too high and intercepted by Jenks. And on the move, Landis Morris. Finally taken down just short of midfield. It's going to be Norman's first turnover of the night. There is a flag back at the 34. So you're going to probably have a block in the back on the return. Either way, it's going to be Jenks' ball.
Yeah, Landis Morris just in the right spot right there. Ball sails on Horton just a little bit when he tries to hit that post route across the middle.
Personal foul, blindside block against the red after the interception. 15 yards from here, Red's ball.
So personal foul, blindside block against Jenks. going to move back to the 20. Actually, the 19. That's where we're going to start, first and 10 from the 19-yard line. Quarterback for Jenks. Ian Corwin's night is over. Kitterman, a sophomore. Hands it off to Jacob Shelley. Oh no, rather it's number 13 that time for Jenks. Roman Hopkins. They start throwing all kinds of new guys at us out here now, aren't they?
They certainly are.
Final 5 minutes of this one. Looks like they've probably unloaded all the starters and have the backups in here at Jenks. The Trojans are going to go on to win this one, so Dion, they will improve. 7-1, 4-1 in district play. So they'll be tied for second place with Santa Fe, and that's who they get next Friday night. And a second down, again, to give to number 13, Roman Hopkins. That'll bring up a 3rd and 2. Dion is ready to head downstairs to do our post-game coach and player interviews. Kitterman tosses up top to Matt McCabe. Senior with a big catch inside the 10-yard line. Wow, all the way down to the 6. But hold on, we got a flag down at the line of scrimmage. And this one may be coming back. It's a 78-yard pickup, but unfortunately for Jenks, it's coming back. See Robert Breedlove say 72, so my guess it's probably a hold on one of the Jenks linemen.
Brett's got linemen downfield, 5-yard penalty, 3rd down replayed.
I don't know if unless he thought it was a run play because the quarterback took about 2 steps and threw the ball. If he had time to even get downfield. Either way, it is a penalty against Jenks. It's a nice pass from Steven Kitterman to Matt McCabe. Kitterman again. Same play to McCabe again. And that one tapped away. Going up a 4th down for Jenks. After the turnover, some of the Trojan fans booing as they want to get McCabe a reception on this senior night. Thought he had it on the previous play. Instead, Jenks will now have to punt. Trojans rotate players in. They had 12 on the field. Jenks' first punt of the night. Taken at the 40 by Luna. And he goes and loses 10 yards trying to make the play, and that's where Norman will start. No flags on this one. Or is there? Yeah, no flags on the play this time, so the Tigers will take over at the 30-yard line. Oh, there is a flag back at the 22-yard line. Now I see it. Tuesday evening at 7 o'clock.
We had illegal procedure against the kicking team. That's added from the end of the place, 5 yards. No, 5 yards this way.
All you have to do is go to yourview.com/boardfan.
Well, 5 yard penalty at the end of the run after Jenks. At motion at the offensive line. 3:07 to go in this. Horton hands it off to Joe Willie, right up the middle. Nice run as he gets about 5 or 6. And Norman quickly back to the line of scrimmage. Dion, you hooked up down there?
Yes, sir, you got
me. Second and 5, Horton the pass. And just too hard of a pass on that quick slant route. It'll bring up a 3rd and 5 with 2:41 to go.
Yeah, he just leads them a little too much right there. Nothing the receiver can do about that.
Willie has rushed 14 times for 100 yards tonight. Horton again. That pass too high. It's going to be 4th down as it was intended for Tyler Crump.
I mean, it hasn't been consistently tonight, but there have been some passes that have gotten away from Horton. Just a little too high on a couple of them that he really wishes he probably could have had it back.
Timeout for Norman. Next Friday night, Edmond Santa Fe takes on Jenks, our Ford game of the week. At a battle for 2nd place in the district, both teams have Jenks will win this one tonight on 4-1. They both have lost to Broken Arrow, so the winner of next Friday night's game will finish 2nd in the district. The loser more than likely will end up 3rd. That's Jenks, Edmond Santa Fe. Next week is the Trojans. Wrap up the season at Santa Fe and at Westmore in the next 2 weeks. Meanwhile, Norman plays Westmore and then Santa Fe in the final 2 weeks. So these two teams facing the same opponents, just switch weeks to wrap up the season. I can't believe we are talking about the final 2 weeks of the season already. And before you know it, it's playoff time. 4th down, Horton's gonna run for it. And he's got the 1st just shy of midfield.
And he gets out of bounds to stop the clock, which they would have stopped anyways to move the chains. But see what this offense can do in this 2-minute drill.
Jenks will not hit the 50-point mark, which they've done in the last 4 wins over this team. Dating back to 2014, they've won 6 straight in the series. Norman beat them first time they played back in 1992 in the 6A semifinals at Lewis Field in Stillwater. That was the last time that Norman won a state championship. First ever 6A championship in the state of Oklahoma. Horton again. Jonah Payton threw it behind him. Payton, I don't think Payton has a reception tonight.
Yeah, it's been a little bit of a frustrating night for Payton. Just passes a little too far out of his reach and a couple of them behind him.
Very frustrating night for him as a junior. Joe Willie, that'll put him over the 100-yard mark. He was right at 100, so that'll get him 109. Nice run there. .130 to go in this one. 4th and short for Norman to get a 1st to keep the drive going. Willie, 1st down for Norman.
Joe Willie in the ball.
had two field goals in the first half and then a touchdown here in half number two as Horton had a 26-yard touchdown run on a nice drive. They cut it to 28-13, and then three plays later, Jenks expanded the lead back to 22, and Trojans have scored a fourth-quarter touchdown, a 15-yard run from Ian Corwin. That's why we're sitting at 42-13. Horton again. Just out of the reach of Andrew Young.
That was a good effort by Andrew Young, though. Full extension over there on the sideline to try to bring that one in. Just bounces off his hand just slightly.
Horton under pressure just throws it away. That's got to be intentional grounding. There was not a receiver in the area. It was two offensive linemen. There's the flag, comes flying in now.
Yeah, it looked like the referee was having a hard time pulling it out of his pocket real quick.
Remember, the rule in high school is different. I mean, I don't even think he was out of the pocket. Even if he was and threw it past the line of scrimmage, it wouldn't matter. You still have to throw it toward the area of a receiver. And they lose the down, so it goes to third.
Lost the down. Third.
Third and more than 10, like 20. Horton looking for someone to throw to, goes deep downfield, has a wide open receiver, and he catches it, Andrew Young, for the touchdown. 50-yard touchdown pass from Horton to Young, who got behind the defense.
He certainly did. One of the guys that I mentioned early in this broadcast, that Andrew Young is going to have a big night for this team to compete with Jenks. He's had a good night, especially this last play right here. Just hasn't been enough for Jenks. But it was a good play and good speed for him to get behind that defense. And you see the arm talent of Horton. He throws that one up in the air and lands in the lap of Andrew. Good touchdown by the Norman Tigers.
PAT is good, makes it 42-20. One more look at it. You see the arm strength of Cade Horton. Why, he's definitely one of the top-ranked baseball players in the state of Oklahoma. He's already committed to play baseball at Ole Miss. I mean, he can't go somewhere else. OU is also offered him. His mind made up right now. He wants to go play in the SEC. In fact, we carried one of their baseball games right here on YurView last spring. Was it Mustang? Mike Davis helped me out, who they played in that, the game we did. Yeah. It's been 6 months ago. It's kind of hard to remember. Maybe it was UConn. I think it was UConn that did a game over there.
You'll figure it out eventually, yeah. Zig.
I have to go back and look at my archives. By that time, we'll be off the air. 52 seconds to go in this one. And Norman will kick off, and if Jenks gets it, run it once or twice or take a knee, and we can go home for another Friday night in the books. Short kickoff. Out of bounds. It was taken that time by Quinn Hill, number 88, another sophomore for Jenks. Again, it was senior night here in Jenks, 25 seniors. Good send-off for them. Final regular season home game of the year. Jenks wins out, they will host a first round playoff game on November 9th. They got to win out. They got to beat Santa Fe next Friday night. We have a Norman player down, but they got to win at Santa Fe next Friday night. Pretty much ensure they get second in the district. Both Santa Fe and Jenks have lost to Broken Arrow, so the Tigers are sitting pretty in first. Broken Arrow also has two games left. Final run of the night.
Good job by the running back following the coach's instructions and not running out of bounds.
We'll get one more play out of it. Kitterman hands off to Roman Hopkins again. I think he fumbled it. He did fumble, turned the ball over, so Norman will have one final shot with 5 seconds to go. One thing you don't want if you're Jenks is a Norman touchdown and then a two-point conversion that would make it a 14-point game. If something were to come down to points at the end of the season, you don't want that to happen.
Yeah.
That one point, you know, that one point, because the most you can outscore anybody by in any given game is 15. Horton's going to go for it, see how far he can throw this one. 55 yards in the air. And incomplete, and that'll do it on this Friday night in Jenks. Fall break is over, week 8 is over. Keith Riggs picks up another win as the Trojans improve to 7-1 on the season with the 42-20 victory tonight over Norman. Jenks now tied with Santa Fe, both teams at 4-1 in district play. And they will square off next week in week number 9. Big night for Noah Hernandez and all the Jenks seniors. Hernandez, 3 touchdowns in the night. Ian Corwin rushed for one and passed for one as well. We'll wrap this one up from Jenks. You're watching the Ford Game of the Week.
You're watching Game Time on YurView. For more in-depth coverage of the top players around, recruiting updates, behind-the-scenes access, and more, check out YurView.com.
During Ford SUV season, find out why more people come back to Ford than any other brand. Here's a reason.
We've got room.
And here's another.
Waze says it's faster to take the side streets.
Perfect.
And by the way, Ford has won more J.D. Power Initial Quality Awards than any other brand. During Ford SUV season, get 0% for 72 months plus 1,000 bonus cash on Escape, Edge, and Explorer. See your Oklahoma Ford dealer today.
You may have heard of Tulsa Tech, but did you know we offer business and industry training for large and small companies? Come get trained and certified in areas like confined space, Hazwoper, crane rigging, CPR, first responder, and more. To learn more about our affordable and customized training and how Tulsa Tech can be a valuable resource to your company, call 918-828-5000 or visit us online at tulsatech.edu.
Winter's just around the corner, so it's a great time to replace your furnace before you need it most.
A planned replacement can save you thousands of dollars while improving the comfort and efficiency of your home.
Don't get caught in the cold. Call Airco Service today.
The company you know.
No one thinks about their water heater until it fails.
At that point, you have a huge mess on your hands with water damage everywhere.
A planned water heater replacement can save you a lot of trouble.
Right now, you can save big on a new high-efficiency water heater.
Call Airco Service.
The company you know.
You're watching Game Time on YurView. For more in-depth coverage of the top players around, recruiting updates, behind-the-scenes access, and more, check out YurView.com.
Back at Allan Trimble Stadium in Jenks, Trojans win it. They're 8-1, 4-1 in district play. Or rather, 7-1, 4-1 in district play. They win it 42-20. Here's Dion with Coach Keith Riggs.
Coach, good, strong performance for your team. How do you feel about the win tonight?
Well, it was a good win for us. We played well. Hats off to Norman. They are a much improved team. They played really hard. Coach Martin's done a great job with them in these 2 years. But good win. We'll take it.
What are you looking to get better at through the rest of the season?
Well, you know, we have to fine-tune some things. We'll watch the film and see. Sometimes you miss it on a Friday night, but we'll watch film and see what we need to fix and just work on those corrections moving forward.
With it being senior night, talk about a couple of your seniors having a big night tonight, and what do you expect from them the rest of the way?
Well, it would be hard to name just two. We've got 27 seniors. Just a great bunch of kids. They love playing with each other. They love being around each other. Just love them to death, and I'm really happy for them on senior night.
Well, we look to see you soon, Coach, and good luck with the rest of the way.
Thank you very much.
Appreciate it, Coach.
Thank you.
All right, thanks a lot, Dion. And Dion's now with one of those seniors and our player of the game.
Standing here with Noah Hernandez, 3 touchdowns on the night, 3 on your chest, 3 touchdowns as well. How do you feel about the team's performance?
It was a good performance. You know, we clicked on offense tonight. Our offensive linemen were hooked up really well tonight. Filled on tackles, we clicked really well tonight. It was a good night.
Speaking of tackles, you're playing both ways. Talk about it a little bit about the defense and what you had to face over there with that Norman team.
We knew that they had a pretty big left side, so we knew that we were going to have to stop the run, stop the counter. They were going to try to spread us out, but we did a really good job tonight. Like I said, gap filling, we did a really good job stopping the run.
Well, it being your last time as a senior playing on this field, express some of those feelings and how it felt tonight.
Man, it's crazy. I played on this field. I came up here in 2015 as a freshman, and I don't know where the time's gone, you know? Sitting here now as a senior knowing I have... This is my last night in the regular season, you know, playing on this field. It's sad, but, you know, it's been a blessing to be able to be a Jenks Trojan.
Well, you certainly blessed this field tonight. Good job, and congratulations on being our player of the game.
Thank you so much.
Back to you, Zig.
All right, thanks a lot, Dion. Appreciate it. Noah Hernandez, very efficient night running the football. 6 carries, 116 yards, 3 touchdowns. You can't beat that, and here is one of them right here. First quarter action, looks like the 37-yarder. He also rushed for 35 to make it 14-3. And there it is there. And then he had a 27-yard touchdown run in the third quarter to make it 28-6. Getting great blocking up front from some of his teammates. And then on defense, hey, he's not just offense. Check him out defensively on the blitz, gets the sack. Jenks wins it 42-20. Hernandez, Noah Hernandez, your player of the game. Well, that's it. Don't forget, join us next week. Oh, we've got the play of the game coming up, too. I forgot about that one. And it's got to be this catch by Harvey Cooper. Second half, Cade Horton back to throw. Finds Harvey Cooper. Look at that, a one-handed grab for the senior. Harvey Cooper, your game time play of the game. Final stats as we look at this is Jenks wins it 439 yards of offense, but you know what? Norman was sticking with them tonight.
Well, you see the numbers right there, 232 yards. Did a good job, but just not enough to win.
19 first downs, 20 for Jenks, 2 turnovers for the Trojans, and 1 for Norman. But the final score is Jenks by 22, 42-20. Don't forget about next week, Thursday night, fourth game of the week will be in Edmond. The Edmond Memorial Bulldogs hosting number 1 ranked and undefeated Broken Arrow Tigers 8-0. Game time at 7 o'clock on YurView. Check out Edmond Memorial BA next Thursday at 7 on YurView Channel 3. And then Friday night, Santa Fe will be back over in Edmond. The Wolves will host these same Jenks Trojans. Game time at 7 on YurView. Check out Jenks and Santa Fe next Friday at 7 on YurView Channel 3. That game will be for second place in the district. Jenks wins that one. They will have one more home game on November the 9th. For Deion Amati and our entire YurView broadcast team, I'm Mike Ziegenhorn. So long from Jenks. Final score 42-20. Jenks wins it. To watch the entire replay of this game, log on to YurView.com. Good night from Jenks America.
7 p.m. Come out.
Game Time on YurView has been brought to you by your Oklahoma Ford dealers, the best in Oklahoma. AirCo, the company you know. Tulsa Tech, for your future success, go to tulsatech.edu. And by Weoki Credit Union. Join us all fall long for some of the top high school football from around the country on Game Time.
Look, if you're not the lead dog, the scenery never changes. That's why this is the view for every other full-size pickup. And this year, it's deja vu all over again. Because only the Ford F-150 gives you best-in-class torque, best-in-class payload, and you got it, baby, best-in-class towing. This is the big dog. This is the Ford F-150. It doesn't just raise the bar, pal. It is the bar.
Now get 0% financing for 60 months plus $4,250 cash back on a new F-150 at your Oklahoma Ford dealer today.
Are you looking to build a career in the high-demand and high-paying field of construction? What are you waiting for? Tulsa Tech offers affordable, hands-on training in state-of-the-art facilities. Great training that can give you confidence. Get trained in fields like carpentry, electricity, HVAC, masonry, and welding. To learn how Tulsa Tech can help you make your own path to a successful career, call 918-828-5000 or visit tulsatech.edu.
Hey, high school football fans, you want your school to get that VIP treatment? Here's your chance. You choose which game will be the Ford Game of the Week November 1st. Here are your choices. Jenks at Westmore, Edmond North at Union, or Enid at Broken Arrow. To vote, go to yearview.com/FordFanPick. Vote early, vote often, and tell your friends. You vote, you decide. Winners will be announced October 24th. For more information and the best in high school football, go to yearview.com.
Let's play a game. How well do you know me? If I said to you, what's the one food I would eat if it was the only food I could eat for the rest of my life, would you know what the answer was? Huh? Would you?